everyone, I'm Emily, your community manager here at HyperRPG, and I just wanted to take a second before the show to let you know that we are currently in the midst of a 48-hour charity live stream for the Halo Foundation. It's super fun. We've got 24 hours of RPGs, we've got a dunk tank, we've got celebrity guests, we've got a ton of fun stuff happening, and we need your help to help raise $150,000 to help get kids off the street. I want you to check out twitch.tv/hyperRPG all weekend. We're starting at 11 a.m. Friday, April 7th Pacific time, and then we are going all the way to Sunday, 11 a.m. Pacific time. No sleeping, just crazy. It's gonna be amazing. You should come check it out and help the kids.
What is that face?
Oh, that feels like my getting ready to RP face.
Hello and welcome to Valiant Vanquish Season 2, episode number, what, three?
Three episodes.
Three. Volume 1.
Mm-hmm. Episodes. What were your guesses? Were you like somewhere between 1 and 10?
Dude, prepping for a charity drive is almost as much like, or as little sleep as the charity drive.
Yeah,
so I'm kind of... It could be episode 10, and we've been at this a long time.
What are we doing, Zach?
What's a charity drive? Well, for those that don't know, I'm guessing a lot of you do know, I don't think we've hit front page yet. When we hit front page, I'll definitely reintroduce the charity drive, but we got a giant 48-hour long charity drive this weekend. You're gonna see a lot of these familiar faces here. It's going to be lots of fun. You know, the whole thing is that for $1,500 USD, we can get a child off the streets into a home and feed them and give them education for an entire year as us sponsoring them. HyperRPG would like to sponsor 100 kids by the end of this event and get them off the streets, and that's a pretty cool fucking thing. Last year, it was a really neat thing. We raised $68,000 total, and like 6 months later, they came back to us and showed us a video of the house that we built, the kids that we were providing education for, what they've been able to do with that education, and it was like, oh shit, this is for real. You really, really, really matter a lot. $1 tips, $2 tips, all those things go a really long way when you're helping at-risk youth in other countries. So that is what we're doing this weekend. There's gonna be tons of guests. It's gonna be a shit ton of fun. We've got a giant schedule that we will be releasing publicly probably tomorrow. And
I might have accidentally tweeted some of it out.
That's fine. It's fine. It's okay.
Danny's so excited.
It's getting close to locked. It's fine.
I'm so excited.
But this, what you are watching, is Valiant Vanquished. It is our Valiant Universe RPG with these wonderful, wonderful people. Why don't you introduce yourself and your character name and your power as we know it right now for the audience, if you don't mind.
Hello, I am Danielle Radford, and I play Karen Lemon. And right now, as we understand my power, I draw things badly, and they come alive, and they come to life. And so we're still trying to figure out how that works. Rest in peace, Stick'em.
Bye, Stick'em.
Not my fault.
Johnny Cruz here. I play Jay Goldston.
Gold.
Jay Gold.
Did you get that hat?
I did. I had to make a hat. I forgot it because I went to work and then I came back right here.
Fuck.
Yeah, I got a hat that's
embroidered.
That's not embroidered. It's like it's literally screwed in.
That made Lucas's Space Cat's hat.
Yeah, with the screws. Yeah, it's really cool. I'll bring it next week.
Bedazzled.
Bedazzled, but with screws. Yeah. my powers, as we know it, is I can make. Cancer grow, which is horrible. Very horrible.
As we know it, Goldstein here has...
Goldstein.
Has...
Just call me Gold, man.
Inadvertently activated an entire group of Psyots. We don't necessarily know yet if he just caused them to have extreme trauma and it happened that way, or if he straight up activated some people and happened to kill everyone who wasn't a potential Psyot in the immediate vicinity, while also being able to somehow see the... like tumors and cancer and make them grow and really sad.
It was fun.
Cool.
Dark. also super dark and serious all the time is Dot Wilson, traumatized high school senior that is played by me, Amy Dallin. And right now, so far, this might be useful someday, but she keeps turning into puddles of water. So let's all pretend that's productive until further notice.
I am Dani Fernandez. I play Noah Castillo. As of right now, we know that she has some type of mind intrusion powers and can read some people's minds. And she might also be in talks with Solomon. We're not sure. Yeah.
Hey, what's up? If you Wadiway, I'm DK Unaka. So far, we know he can get really light and float and bouncy, or he can get solid and hard and heavy.
Thanks for clarifying.
dense, so he controls his density. Yeah, and you know, he's just trying to keep it together. You know, he recently revealed he has a mission to do something that no one has really been able to do in the Valiant universe, which is to put a stop and end to Toyo Harada. He kind of has a beef with him.
That's kind of... We're going to have to dive deeper into that, because... He's got a beef with Toyo Harada. And
I mean, it's a one-sided beef. Toyo doesn't know he exists.
For him,
it's a beef. It's a beef, you know? But, you know, Toyo may not know, but,
so
you know,
funny.
When he knows, you know, who knows?
Okay, so there are many different ways that you can interact with this show. One of which is that you can send these guys plot points. Now, for those that are watching, maybe new, or those that have been watching for a long time, this entire network runs somewhat like a live Kickstarter. Your interactions financially allow us to keep paying the talent, paying to keep the lights on, paying the crew. We work really hard to bring you guys this content, and it's one of the ways that you can help us keep it going. So, to do that, we try to create ways for you to interact financially. We don't feel like you're just tipping us, you're actually affecting the show as it happens. So every $100 earned towards an individual character using the hashtag of their name when you tip gives them a plot point. Now with a plot point, they are allowed to do crazy things, restore their health, do a reroll on an important dice roll, or, you know, just take over for a little bit as lead narrator and do something wild. That is one of the ways you get to interact. The other way is that we actually have a bit game going on. Now this bit game is something we worked with Pillowzak to create, and for some reason Pillowzak decided he was going to be the villain tonight. So yay. You're fighting against Pillowzak and Arislan clones. Ooh. So please stop them. Please stop them. And since Pillowzak built the game, he may or may not be a little bit overpowered. So yeah. Yeah. Please stop him. Now to do that, you can send bits to attack the using different villains or different heroes in the Valiant universe, and just stop them, just please. It's a whole ordeal. A little too much ego on those guys. You know what I mean?
And too much pillows that I've modeled after.
A pillow that was made.
I know.
Yeah, I didn't choose that. That wasn't a life choice. Where it's like,
I'm just saying,
pillow.
Take responsibility for your children.
Uh huh.
Wait, like a waifu? Like someone's like.
Yeah, it was
I know.
It was
an body, body
it was
pillow.
A Zach, anime Zach body.
Can
pillow.
We all? Can we get one? Okay.
No. No, this is old news.
I've
it's old news.
It feels new so news. New though.
Oh yeah, it does. Mm-hmm. Feels new to me.
Great. those are the ways you can interact with the show. It's going to be a wild ride, so thank you guys for tuning in. If new people come into the chat room, please answer their questions, let them know about all the awesome stuff we're doing here with the Valiant Universe. Oh, we can announce this now. The Valiant Summit will be here on April 17th.
Yay!
The official
yes.
Valiant Summit.
Yay!
They will be making announcements for their next year of books that are coming out. There will be announcements about this show. There will be announcements about the future of Valiant on TV and film, all happening right here. We'll be streaming it live on HyperRPG and hosting the entire event from our studio. Pretty fucking awesome. It's like a nerd dream come true. A couple years ago, I was like, I really want to do stuff with Valiant. Now we're hosting their damn summit here. It's awesome.
There is a level of if you build it, they will come that's sort of insane, where Zach's just like, I'm just going to get a house and then somehow convince everyone to come do things in it.
Yeah, so I don't ever have to leave or have friends.
He pays his friend.
Would you rather me not? All right. Are you guys ready to? You guys ready to do this?
Yeah.
You ready to do some role playing fun? Why do you keep looking at that board to see if you got pop points
up there? I mean, I am too.
I've been looking.
I don't know if my charm won anyone over.
Zach's gonna get defeated.
He really buffed himself for this one.
Oh, Zach!
If the villain gets defeated, these guys all get a plot point, so they're just... You guys, don't pay attention to that game.
I'm looking.
Okay. Let's do this. Let's do this. Here, I cue the light change. We're gonna get into it. We open on our group inside of an old Winnebago traveling through the desert somewhere in Nevada. You've been following a long road for what appears to be quite a long time now, at least an hour, sitting in almost complete silence. The last we saw the individuals in this story, they were confronted with a strange individual known as Dumoko, who had a very large, to some, a dog, but was actually a wolf. Things got weird very quickly, and they were told that they had to get in the Winnebago and leave. So Noah has been driving for at least an hour as they sit in silence.
Show me that smile again. Don't waste another minute on your crying. Where will you begin? The best is ready to begin. Okay. Whoa, whoa, whoa. As long as we've got each other, we've got the world sitting right in our hands, baby. Rain or shine. All the time, we've got each other, sharing the laughter and love. Oh, I love to share the love. Wow, wow. You go low, I got wow. You go low. Ah.
I don't think he knows the song.
I know this song, okay.
I don't think you actually know the song.
No, I knew this song. My voice, my throat was warming up. My throat was warming up to the song.
Sing it.
No, go ahead.
No, because I was singing and now my mouth is dry and I cannot sing anymore. I'm sorry.
Oh yeah, the desert air.
Yeah, I was, you know, I was in it and you guys ruined it. I was like right in the middle of the song. Now my throat is not ready.
Then I was in choir for a while, but I don't know that one.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh.
Choir? How old are you?
18.
Still in high school, or?
Well, I was.
Wait, did you graduate?
No. I don't like the way you said that. I do not like the inflection that came out of your mouth when you said that. The inflection that came out of your mouth when you said that it was not
I think you misunderstand. Like 18 is 18. I'm not supporting what he said. I'm just saying that if you're trying to make the argument that asking if she's graduate.
I'm a senior in high school.
Okay. So still a senior in high school? That's cool. What do you sing in the choir?
We do like a lot of madrigals.
Yeah?
Oh, okay. Yeah. Are the classes hard? You know, I was taking AP Juro, Honors English, college level science, calculus, you know, all the
AP or BC?
Calculus, C, yeah. It's okay. It gets better.
How old are you?
19. So I have some wisdom.
Yeah, you got a whole year of wisdom on top of.
Yes, I do. Okay.
You're in college now? Is it?
Yeah, I just finished my first year. I was in UCLA. What college did you go to, Mr. Clerk?
Uh Yeah, I didn't go to college.
Well, you know, that is fine. Neither did Steve Jobs.
I do have a job, though.
Yeah, you know, I got a job too. I work in the campus library. You know,
probably pays just as well as my cashier job, honestly.
Yeah, yes. But you know, it was good. It was good.
Hey, Noah.
Hey, what?
Are you still in high school?
No, I'm 27.
You know, you are the only person under the age of 30 that I see use two hands when they drive a car.
She totally does. Vroom, vroom. I'm Noah.
These are rocky roads.
10 and 2.
We are on a freeway. We are not on a mountain. We are not going off.
These are unpaved. I don't see you driving.
Oh, that's because I chose not to.
Yeah, because you chose not to.
No, I chose not to.
I'm pretty sure she's the only person that volunteered to drive.
Yes, that is true.
Thank
but
you
I
for
also
driving.
Chose not to.
Where are we going, by the way?
I don't. We're driving.
You know, is anyone hungry? I feel like it's been a while. Maybe we go to a little Caesar's.
Let's go. Look, there's so many, you know, let's go to the Papa John's over there. Or look, over there's McDonald's and there's Burger King. Yeah, there's so many places. Well,
I mean, when we see one.
Did anyone check the fridge in the RV?
Oh, no, I don't eat random RV food.
Is it okay?
I eat random soups in the desert, but I do not eat random RV food.
I mean, it's our RV now, right?
True.
That's true.
Is it okay?
I think that it's probably fine if we want to see if there's like some kind of food or something.
Okay, yeah.
You want to take a look? Go ahead. Yeah, go ahead, DK. Yeah, go see. Go see what the food stitch is.
Well,
DK heads to the midsection of the RV to check the refrigerator. Jim walks up to the front and sits next to Noah and opens the glove compartment. Inside, he finds a pink slip and an owner's manual and kind of pulls it out. Looks like it's ours now.
Wow.
That was weird though, right?
Yes, it is weird for someone to just like give you their car.
Yeah.
And force you off their property.
Right. Yeah.
The guy had a pet wolf. I mean, he was weird.
Was that a wolf?
Yes, he was.
Hey, it might have been a Shiba.
Why was your nose bleeding, by the way?
Oh, I have allergies. It's dry out
desert
here.
Desert allergies?
Yeah, super dry.
You're allergic
allergies
to sand?
In the desert.
A lot of people are allergic to sand.
Like Anakin really? Skywalker? Like
yeah.
You know that's
Wait,
from a movie,
Anakin's
right?
Skywalker is allergic to sand?
Yeah, he just hates it because it's coarse and it gets all
well,
over the place.
That's different than being allergic.
Right.
If you got sand,
you just hate
it's like
sand, or are you
sandpaper.
Allergic?
It's like sandpaper up in your nose.
Why is
why
dust,
were you sniffing sand?
The dust blew it up in there.
I don't remember it being windy enough to get a bunch of like sand in your nose.
I mean, obviously it did. She got a nosebleed.
She's lying.
Thank you, Doc.
All right.
Oh,
well,
God.
Do you search the fridge, by
yes.
the way? When you open the fridge, you see nothing but cans of Surge filling the entire fridge.
Jackpot.
What is this?
Oh, this is something called Surge. See, it stopped coming out here, but I tell you what, there's so much Surge in Nigeria. I'm like, it's like I'm at home.
It tells me what.
Yeah,
tells me what.
It's a carbonated beverage. I don't think I should toss it to you. I will pass it.
No, toss it to him.
Toss it to him.
Toss it.
Okay,
toss that.
Hey, what's going on back there? Oh, now I'm all sticky.
This is super sugary.
It's good.
Hey, DK, why don't you see if there's anything in them cabinets?
Okay.
So you open up the cabinets next to the fridge, and it's just stacks and stacks of ramen noodles, like instant ramen.
Hey, ramen.
It looks like we have food. All we need is a little hot water, and then we'll be able to have some dinner.
You could actually just eat it dry.
Yeah. Right.
Do you
yeah.
know how RVs work? There's a sink next to the
okay.
fridge. I mean, there's is there and a microwave.
Okay, you know. All right. You know, I like using a kettle. You put it, you know, I feel like it's better. I don't know if you know what happens when you microwave water, you
Can
know.
Can you roll for intellect for me, please? So as he's saying that, he starts digging through all the other cabinets inside the RV. Now, the inside of this RV is an old, like, 1970s solid wood paneling, wood 11. Everything. It's been kept in extremely, extremely good shape, though. 11?
Mm-hmm.
You find an actual kettle with some butane cans under Ooh. The sink.
Now we are talking. So you get your microwave ramen, and you taste my kettle ramen, and you see which one you like is better.
I mean, it's all just going to taste like noodles, right?
Yeah,
it doesn't suddenly not be 25-cent noodles.
But you can taste it in the water. You can taste it. You know, like if you make coffee, you just, you know, you get the coffee and you microwave the water and you pour it in the coffee, you're like, it's okay, but it's okay. But if you go ahead and get a kettle and you pour the, let it, you know, pour it and you let it bloom and you put it in, you just, you know, keep pouring it.
Yeah, so anyway.
I don't think that that's true.
I guarantee you it's true. Do it to your coffee.
Look, I don't know how far we are from, well, wherever the hell we actually are. And I'm guessing you drive a road long enough. Noah, how are we doing on gas?
I don't know. It looks like we have less than half a tank.
Where even are we?
Well, hopefully we get somewhere. I mean, how big's the Nevada desert?
The desert?
Anyway.
Oh.
I don't know. I feel like if we're driving in the desert, eventually there will be a rest stop. Maybe a diner. Eat some pancakes.
I don't know, this is a big RV. I feel like someone could check and see if there's maps and a compass or something in any of the cabinets. I don't know, it seems like people have a lot of free hands back there.
Or maybe we can use our phones because it's not 1985 or something.
You know, you would have one free hand if you weren't driving with both of them.
it's a rocky road.
Oh, that's
and I have a lot of lives that I'm in charge of right now. I have a lot of lives. I have a lot of important cargo.
So you think you're in charge of all of our lives right now?
Uh-oh.
Yeah.
Uh-oh.
Jim, just move away from me. I haven't had anything to eat and I'm very hangry.
Yo, DK, why don't you make some ramen for no, I'm gonna move to the back.
Yeah. I'm gonna move up to the front.
All right.
That wasn't
Jay sits
what
down
I meant.
Right next
hey,
to you.
What's up? Co-pilot.
Hey.
Hanging out.
Yeah. I wouldn't call it co-pilot, but yeah. Okay.
I mean, you just need to go straight.
Right. Are you mansplaining the driving to me?
No.
Just go. Okay.
What's up with you?
I think he just wanted you to keep going straight.
Right, that seems
like he was telling you to just keep going straight.
Yeah.
I mean, there's only one way to go, there's no turn off.
Okay, sure. I mean, I thought that's what I was doing, but.
I'm just here to help.
No, you've been doing it way better since he told you that you have to go straight.
Thank you.
You are killing going straight right now. Thank you so much, Gold.
Yeah, great job.
Do you, are you always so tight?
Oh, see, I don't like the way that sounds already.
No,
I'm
yeah,
telling
real.
You,
real.
Everything
you
that
meditate?
Comes out your mouth, I do not like.
Do you do anything
to relax your body?
Yeah, yogas.
You meditate or you do yoga?
Yeah,
Do you do like yoga in a class with a bunch of other people?
With
like,
a bunch of girls, yeah.
And loud music and yeah. Like, okay.
That's the same thing. However you meditate. Right?
Right. Yeah, you focusing real hard in that class, right? Clearing your mind.
Yeah. You know, stretching a little bit, talking to the people around me.
Hey, is anyone checking anything, any of the cabinets?
Right,
Could you please check?
Yes, I am checking. Did you not hear my noodles inventory report? I did just not too long ago.
Do you want to roll an intellect for me?
I want to look for maps, yeah. With the D12 or without?
With. So your intellect with a D12 rolling.
13.
What do you find?
I mean, ideally a map.
Well, if that's what you want in there, I rolled a low as I can possibly roll, so.
Okay, a map and like a trove of money.
Yeah, I walked into that one.
Yeah.
So,
I mean,
you find a map, and underneath it is a small kind of like old metal box that, you know, they used to have at, you know, junior high basketball games to hold the money in, kind of thing. And you pull that out and you open it up, and there's $10 inside of there.
Well, this will not get us very far at a motel, but
what is it?
Like $10 and a map.
A map,
but also $10.
Okay.
Okay, have you seen any signs?
No, there's nothing out here, just desert.
So where are we trying to go? How about that?
Civilization!
Question?
I'm so trying to find a city, anything.
What? What?
What?
Like, you have to choose where we want to go. You just want to go just anywhere? Civilization? Huh?
Yeah. I was trying to move us away from that tent and that weird creep dude.
Okay.
Did you want to stay there?
No.
We could have left you there, DK.
We didn't actually have the option because he told all of us to get the fuck out.
Yeah. He said this is our beat, so you don't get to decide who stays and who goes, okay?
Actually, that's a good question. Who gets to sign the pink slip?
I guess.
What?
What?
Paper, rock, scissors.
Who's going to own the RV?
Paper, rock, scissors tournament.
Is that your highest? Do you want to keep this RV?
Well, I mean, I mean, you guys got homes?
Well, I did, but we're all weirdos stranded in the middle of a desert, torn away from our lives, and apparently all we have is an RV that we share.
And $10.
And $10.
Don't forget the ramen and Surge.
Yes.
Are you homeless?
Well, I got a job. I mean,
do you sleep at work?
Oh, wait, what?
I got a job.
Where do you work?
At a grocery store.
Where do you sleep?
Places.
What kind of places?
People sleep places.
No. Give me a place name, like where do you sleep?
Okay, I'm saying, can you keep your nose out of these?
No, it's fine.
Well, he wants the RV.
It's fine. I'm just, you know, I'm saying.
What happened?
Well, I got.
Look,
whenever talk, what happened?
All right,
why are you homeless?
It wasn't always that way, all right? I don't know what you guys' situation was before all this, but my name being on that list was the worst thing that ever happened to me. I got ran out of my town. People that were my friends my entire life, that my family, people I thought that cared for me, and all that I'd done for my community. A couple years ago, that someone in our town found that list. My name's on it. And I wasn't allowed to stay. I didn't ever think I was gonna leave, you know, place I'd lived my entire life. So I didn't have much. I didn't have, you know, savings and stuff. And it's not easy to find a job right now, so I hotel for a while, but then that ran out. And
look,
I'm not a druggie, so
I get it. Look, you've said enough. I think we all can agree here. You had it rough. We understand. So I think we can all agree on this outcome that, you know, when all this is over, you can join our superhero team and share this RV with us.
You are the worst person I've met in my entire life.
How are we going to get around if we don't have our vehicle / you know, we need this, okay? So he can join the team and he can sleep in there with us.
This isn't Scooby-Doo. This is not a mystery van.
But what if it was?
This is basically Scooby-Doo. This is just like Scooby-Doo, except we have powers.
The monsters are real.
Yeah, I don't know what Scooby-Doo you were watching.
It's literally not Scooby-Doo at all.
Yeah, it's real Scooby-Doo. A video when it was really
when
monsters.
All the people like
with their heads
blew
exploded?
Up into small pieces you're flying and
well, you know, like I said, floating. Except we have powers, but the monsters was real, and we have monsters, and we're gonna deal with these monsters. We're gonna train and we're gonna find out what is wrong with you.
There's nothing wrong with me.
There's everything wrong with you.
Oh, there's a lot wrong with you.
I mean, since I'm sharing, I get it. I'm not like you. I'm still a nobody, but.
Maybe you don't know that.
Your ability is to survive tragedy.
You don't know
yeah,
that.
Yeah, you probably
yet.
Have my abilities some.
Like a cockroach. Like an epic, like, blast, you'd still be alive.
Let's not find out.
So wait, but I did survive.
Right.
Everyone else was dead.
Like a cockroach.
Yeah. Do you think I'm like...
Mr. Cockroach.
Like Jason in the back? You think that I'm... I can like heal or... And indestructible or...
Ooh, well, we can find out.
Yeah.
Well,
draw something to stab
him with.
Draw something to stab him with.
Okay.
Hey, wait, what's going on?
We're gonna see if I'm indestructible.
Jim.
We're gonna see if I'm indestructible.
What?
Okay. What should I draw to stab him with?
The knife thing.
Maybe draw another sticker.
No, no more stickers.
Okay, hold on.
No more stickers. I will pull this car over.
Where's Manju? Where's Manju? Where's Manju?
Okay. And so I draw another stickum.
Can you roll your power for me, please?
Here's a 12. And do.
And
it's a four.
With a d12, since you're not rolling to attack. The fuck?
Nine and four.
A 9 and 4, but 4 is my luck.
Yeah, and I, again, rolled the lowest I can possibly. It's going to be one of those nights for me. So because 1 is my lucky number, 2 is a critical fail for me. So so I keep rolling 2s now instead of 1s. So yes, that does succeed. And as you draw the shape, the small knife-like creature that looked somewhat similar to before, but now he has 2 right feet instead of 2 left feet, pops up off of the paper and immediately starts speaking to DK. Apparently having a memory of his life before.
Hey, buddy.
Hey, how's it going? How are you doing, Stick'em?
Hey, weird cartoon thing. Stab me.
Okay.
Wait, Stick'em, but no effort. Like maybe a paper cut or something.
Well, hey, Stick'em, hey, buddy.
Hey, Mom.
So can you just like, not, just like nick him, but not like super hard?
Okay, that's what I was born to do.
And so at that point, Stick'em, runs up, and he's running really, really fast. Like, you think he's gonna go
but
and jab
so
right
small,
into him.
It's like...
he's so small.
Hey, what's going on back there?
Stick him just kind of, because his head is a knife, he just kind of, like, lightly headbutts on the arm.
I mean, you say lightly. I need you to roll for that. So, you're gonna roll your action. And I'll be rolling Jim's action, so we're basically rolling off here. Without a d12, just your action.
Oh, just my action?
Yeah. You're in attack phase here.
3.
Okay, so Stig'em runs up at full speed, and then just, where did you say he goes for, though?
He just right on the arm.
The arm, so he like kind of jumps up, and you see this little paper-like thing kind of flying in the air and sticks into his arm, going kind of like 3/4 of the way in, and you just see Stick'em's little feet hanging out of the arm. No, I still feel it! I feel it! It hurts! Get out! Rips him and throws him across the room, and he slams into the wall on the opposite side as he's got just a giant gash in his arm, bleeding out now.
Oh!
Why are you mad? You told me to stab you!
Was there a, first aid kit in here? Did you see a first aid kit under the sink? Shit.
I take off my shirt. I take off my shirt. I reveal my 6-pack abs. And I go over to the gym and I tie my shirt around his arm.
And as the blood starts soaking through your shirt, he kind of looks at you and he's like, "You're a fucking idiot."
Why? I saved your life.
What did you roll?
That was to look for a 6-pack. It's a bit hard to read these days. They're gorgeous though. 15.
As you're tying it on, Dot's standing right behind you with the first aid pack and bandages.
Nice shirt though. So I'm just going to just be shirtless this whole ride.
I'm not gonna wear sound a gray like, shirt. That's
just
not,
okay. Now this whole place smells like Jakar. You know, I don't know. Why you did that?
Why does it smell like Axe body spray up in here?
Nothing.
Why is no one telling me what's going on?
Jay Goldstein took his shirt off, and now
you gotta be impressed. After this whole night, I still smell good.
Everyone, keep your clothes on.
Too late.
I don't.
Here.
Yeah. So he kind of unties the shirt and takes it over to the sink and plops it down and starts bandaging himself up and kind of running it off in the water. Do you think Stickum, like, can give me tetanus or something?
Oh, I have no idea.
Hey, buddy, how's your arm?
I guess I'm not indestructible, and I don't appear to be healing either.
So it's something else.
Missy yeah. Cockroach, I'm telling you.
Stickum standing next to him on the wall by the sink, laughing.
That's funny as fuck.
Oh, Stickum, I have missed you so much.
I missed you too. You're my best friend.
Oh, you're my best friend
too.
Do you
too. Like, remember everything that happened?
Stickum, do you remember everything that happened? I remember walking off to save all of you because I love you so much. Aww. And then it just got dark. And now I'm back here.
You love us
in
all
Winnebago.
So much. I mean, I know I just asked you to stab me, but you did not hesitate and you were just laughing at me bleeding out here in the sink.
Hey, you know, birds gotta fly. Stickum's gotta stick.
Hey, you cannot disagree with poetry
like
that.
Hold on, I'm writing that down because that's gotta be a t-shirt.
You can't disagree with poetry like that. That is some real poetry coming from that right there.
Is anyone looking at the map?
Is anyone looking at the road? Because you keep
our compass?
Okay.
I'm driving!
I'll try a compass. As a matter of fact, I will just go on my phone and I will use the Google Maps and open it up and see where we are.
Okay, can you roll intellect for me, please?
Oh boy, I'm not going to have a phone, am I? Here you go, Doc.
Thank you. I'm just leaving my dice there forever. That's my thing, forgetting
Here
my dice.
Go. Here we go, I feel it in my juices. God damn it. Oh, guess what? My luck is too.
Great, so you turn on your phone, open up Google Maps and turn on your location services and are able to see exactly where you're headed.
Okay. Still don't feel good about this, but here's where we are. Noah, on my phone, on my GPS.
Okay, I technically can't look at it because I'm driving.
Oh,
but
my
could you tell
goodness.
Me?
Are you worried about getting a ticket?
It's not safe to look at the phone and drive at the same time.
Okay.
Yeah,
that's
totally true.
So do we want to find a restaurant? Or do we want a gas station? Or do we want just the nearest city?
Maybe like a hospital for the stabbed dude?
Oh yes. Oh, excuse me.
No hospitals.
Yeah, my friend just got stabbed.
Wait,
and
what?
No, it wasn't us. It was a cartoon guy that we made without powers.
Are we fine? The bleeding, it's fine. Don't worry about it.
Put some pressure on it. We're not going to the hospital. Why?
I've got pressure on it, but thanks, Mom.
Okay, so.
She's just trying to help.
Besides that, where should we look to go?
That's a really good question. Where are we?
Where are we?
Yeah, first, yeah, I would pinch my phone, do like zoom out and see like my general
area. You don't have to tell us what you're doing, just do it.
That's true. I'm pinching my phone to zoom out just so I want you to know where I am.
DK, where are we?
Oh my God.
You look like you're about 200 miles west of Vegas.
Okay, so.
Let's go to Vegas.
No! We are 200 miles west of Vegas.
Vegas?
Vegas.
Hey, I know some people
fitting
in
right
Vegas.
In without a shirt on, he'd be.
Vegas.
I know some people. Well, we do have.
Vegas.
Yep. We do have.
Vegas. 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 Vegas.
You can
Vegas.
Revive.
Don't read this.
We need
no,
money.
We, revive the Vegas.
We need money in order to get wherever it is that we're going to
Actually,
go next.
You know, they got a point there, like. There's only $10 in this thing,
okay.
And you're like the best gambler in the world.
That's
best
not
idea.
What I'm supposed
well,
to
you
use
know,
this
let's
for.
Do it. Let's go to Vegas.
Let's go to Vegas.
Let's go to Vegas, yes. Baby.
Let's go to Vegas.
Yes.
How old do you have to be to go?
I don't think you can get into.
Yeah,
right?
just jumping up RV. Front with Noah and see how she's doing.
Maybe I can draw you an ID.
I don't know because Stickum doesn't look like a sword, so I don't think.
I won't know until I try. Can I try to do you an ID?
Oh, Okay, I'm just going to be up here with Noah and see what she's doing.
So really you're gonna try to draw.
I'm in trouble, but I really want to know if you can do that.
And who exactly are you trying to draw the ID for? Which
I'm drawing it for Dot because Dot is 18.
Okay, so go ahead and roll for that.
Okay.
Your power.
And a D12.
Yes.
Do 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 do. All right. I got 6, but I rolled 4, which is my luck.
Perfect. So you draw an ID, which is a very crude kind of like outline of an ID with the information. You take Dot's current ID and you try to copy and trace over some of the elements, and then you try to kind of trace over her face to get a close resemblance, and then it kind of pops out of the frame, and you've got this resemblance of an ID. But the image starts to talk to you, and what appears to be an impersonation of Dot, as if it's the way you see Dot and impersonating her.
Oh my God! Hi, guys. What's
What?
What's going on? Hey, who are you?
You're like a tiny me.
Hey,
oh
guys,
my God.
I wanted to let you
That's
know.
That's so cool.
I don't really care, but you did that, and the knife thing disappeared.
Thank God.
Oh. Stick him!
Stick him!
I swear, I feel like you are playing with my emotions constantly.
There was a knife here?
I mean, we're learning something now. She can only have one of these things at once. Like, that's good, right? We're learning about each other.
Yeah, I guess.
So,
yeah,
that's good.
Yeah, we did a thing.
Moving and trying to see if the tiny bee moves with me.
Oh, that's fun. This is like a mirror game.
Yeah.
Oh, that's cool.
I don't think that's going to pass for an ID, but you can try.
Let me see. Tiny Amy? Tiny Dot? Tiny Dot.
Hi. Oh,
careful.
Wait. Stay still. Stay still.
Oh, your hands are all squishy.
Someone take that away from him.
Tell him to stay still. Because you got to act like an ID. Stay still.
What?
Why are you pinching me so hard?
He is doing.
I'm trying to help
here. I'm telling you.
Can I just?
I'm going to use a plot point here, and you hear a sound from the back of kind of like moving around and crashing, and then moving really quickly. Hey guys!
What?
I found something. And you all remember in that moment that at the very beginning of the trip, Jason had locked himself in the very back of the RV to stay as far away from Jay as possible, and just kind of forgot about him. Guys, I found something.
Are you okay? Oh. What is it?
I found a tape.
A tape?
Yeah.
Like a cassette tape?
A videotape.
What?
Like VHS?
Can someone come grab it? I don't want to go out there.
It's not well, time is there for a entertainment.
Is there a VCR?
Why would there be a VCR?
Exactly. So why do we care about the videotape if there's no VCR to watch it?
Is there a VCR?
Can you roll intellect for me?
That's a 10. That's an 8. 10.
As you say that, you turn and look behind you and immediately see, kind of hanging up on the wall, an old, you know, you didn't even think to look for it. It's an old CRT kind of television with a VCR built into it, just up on the wall behind you.
Oh my God, I have not seen one of these things in so long.
I don't even know if I know how to use that.
My granddad had one of these.
Really? They're creepy.
This just got really weird for those of us over 25. Jason, Deke, grab the tape, man.
Oh, sorry. I'm up here with Noah. I was having a drive, but I will get your tape.
Just stay still.
So DK gets out of the front, walks to the very back of the RV. As you open the door, you see Jason looking extremely pale and sweating all the way at the opposite end of the vehicle, kind of holding the tape out for you.
Play it. I think it's for us.
Okay, yeah, we got to do something about you.
Yeah, I don't feel too good.
Okay, we got to find some way to turn off Jay. All right. I used the tape. Let's put it in the VCR, I guess.
I don't want to do that.
Why don't you want to do it?
No, I don't know how.
You have it. Just stick it in there.
All right. See, everything you say.
Do you have, like,
on the tape, as you push it into the VCR, you notice the front of it is labeled, Play Me Imbeciles.
Mm. I wonder what that means.
I don't know.
I knew DK was gonna be here.
Burn.
Okay, okay, the goof guy. The goof guy wants to be.
The tape kind of sucks up into the device and you turn the TV on as it flashes. You see a little bit of static, and then Dumoko comes up on screen with his very large coat and jewelry, and it seems like he's being lit by one single light, but also sitting in front of a very obviously placed backdrop of, you know, like an old school pictures kind of backdrop. So he put some thought into this for you.
What's going on?
Hello, my lovelies.
Wait, can you turn it up?
Hello.
Okay.
What are you?
I turned it up, listen.
Sorry so much about earlier. I'm so sorry. I just, if you're here now and you're watching this, you're most likely in the RV that I purchased for you. No. Now, please do take care of it. It means a lot to me. I've had it properly shielded for you, so you don't have to worry about Mr. Straw coming after you. Now, I took proper precautions. His ego will keep him from looking until it's too late if you just keep driving. So just keep driving, you fucking idiots. Just keep driving, and
not
you're fine.
Not necessary language.
You're fine. Now, as I said, I properly shielded this entire RV, so just don't ever go out of it for more than a couple hours, and you'll be fine. Now, I understand the five of you may be very confused, and you kind of look over at Jim holding his arm. I guess this means the tape was made before. Well, yeah, it had to be made before. Yes. Oh, this is weird.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
You have a very long journey ahead of you. I'm sorry I couldn't tell you more when I met you, but I did everything I could. You'll hear more from me soon. Now, I need you to pay very close attention to me. You're all extremely fucking dangerous. Now don't do anything stupid. Take care of yourself. Take care of each other. You're going to need each other. I want you to meet someone. They're in Vegas, and I know you're heading that way.
Yes.
Her name is Jin. Jin Below Zero, to be precise, which is a stupid fucking name, but you can't tell her otherwise. She's a very powerful woman. She'll be able to help you with your predicament. Now, since you're going to be a team and you're all going to stay together and be somewhat functional, I've went ahead and got you matching outfits for your journey.
What?
Okay. If you'll check under the bed in the back, you just, please, I'll wait. Go ahead.
Noah, do you want to pull over?
Go ahead.
I'm
waiting. Just, okay, now that you've tried on your outfit.
Oh. Pause the video.
You're fast-forwarding it.
Okay, will you do it, Mr. Goof Guy?
You pause it and rewind a little bit, and then pause
just
it again.
Just hit back.
Okay, somebody want to go do that thing?
Yeah, I'll go get these suits.
What are you guys doing?
Yeah. Nothing.
But.
Why do you always say that?
Because we ain't doing nothing.
It's like a video, and I guess we have outfits.
What do you mean outfits?
The weird guy left us clothes.
Whip it out, DK.
I swear to you.
Oh my god, I'm dying with idiots.
Here it is.
You pull the boxes out and take them into the front and set them down on the small kind of fold-out table that's underneath the television. As you open it up, you realize there are five large fur coats, all with your names on them on a name tag.
All right. This is right.
You know, I was so ready to pull some cool spandex suits out with maybe and the fur coats. Fur coats?
Yeah, fur coats.
Yeah, put it on, DK.
You said you wanted a costume.
Yeah, well, this is too hot. We're going to Vegas and we're wearing fur coats.
This is the desert.
No, we're going to be the fur crew, man.
You know what? This guy seems to know things about us.
Yes.
Maybe we need those while we're in Vegas. Let's hit play again and see what else.
He apologized for not telling us more, but he obviously didn't plan to tell us more because he recorded this before we came. What?
You are so right. We gotta keep playing it so we can see what his.
Yes, we'll play.
Did anybody
You're
else hear him say
it,
that
man.
His wolf
okay,
is
well,
mad
you do
at us?
Mr. Goof, man.
So now that you've got your outfits, I hope you like. I worked very hard to get you the most expensive and luxurious of, well, just take care of them, just like I said, take care of yourselves. Now those outfits, they'll also help you for a little bit, keeping you shielded from any Psyod invasions that might happen when you're out in public, but they're not gonna protect you for long, especially if you're close to anyone who can get through them. Now, so please, wear them, always. Now I understand that a few of you in the group, Dot particularly, doesn't think that I should be trusted. Now, that's absolutely stupid. And just don't listen to her. She's young and impressionable. Just tell her something special and she'll believe you and you
this
can move
isn't
on.
Helping.
So
yeah, I feel like she wasn't supposed to see this part. I feel like this part, so like one designated person should have probably watched this and, you know, reported, because Dot, I don't think she was supposed to hear that. It's okay,
I'm offended
Dot.
For you.
You all have a very long journey ahead of you. Now, I'm very sorry about what's to happen next, but it's all part of your building block to continue heading towards.
Can you rewind that really quick? I'll rewind it. Did he say what I think he said?
Now, I'm very sorry about what's going to happen next, but it's all part of a very valuable building block.
Hold on, what? Let me rewind that.
Yes.
Now, I'm very sorry about. Damn it. The tape stops playing. As it starts moving in and out.
These
Oh my goodness.
I'm sorry, guys. I was just really wanted to hear what you said.
The tape ejects, and as it kind of falls out of the thing, a long line of kind of stringy tape kind of falls
what
out.
What the heck?
Oh, man.
Well,
maybe
great.
There's
you
a DVD
the
back there.
No, I feel like if we take time and teamwork, we can rewind this gear on the tape back to get it back.
That thing is super broken.
We can do it.
We can do it.
Let's do it.
Do it.
You gotta get the bit of it that's still stuck in the VCR that's up top.
Oh, we'll take it out delicately so the tape doesn't rip.
Yeah.
Me?
Yeah, because yes. we're gonna go back.
I hate you all so much. So I reach up and I reach into the VCR. I don't even remember how VCRs work. And I'm kind of digging around on the inside to see if I can get the tape. It's
don't
obviously
let it, like,
stuck
eat your
in
hands.
There.
So you're kind of standing on top of the table and reaching on there as the two of you are underneath, like holding the tape, waiting for her to move it out. And in that moment, a giant bump kind of hits the entire vehicle. I need you to roll your action for me with a D12, and I need the two of you to roll your might with a D12. You hear a loud popping sound as then the entire RV starts shaking,
and
you start to veer off to the right.
No!
Oh no! 7.
4 and 6, but 4's my lucky.
Sorry, I had a brain fart. 15.
Okay.
Guys, something's not right!
So you immediately pull off to the side of the road. The bump causes you to fall, and as she's falling, both of you move out of the way, not catching her as she hits the ground, and you take 2 damage as you kind of hit.
Y'all are dicks!
You hear Jason from back, what's happening? What's going on out there?
I don't know. I'm gonna stop this huge thing. I don't know. I think we might have a flat tire or something.
Did the creepy guy just tell us on a video that we were about to get a flat tire?
That
no,
was it. That
he
was it.
Didn't.
That was,
that was
it.
Not it.
That was probably it.
It could have been it.
That was probably it.
My butt hurts.
I don't know. Do you think that's bad enough to be like precognition?
No, I do not trust that guy. I wouldn't trust that guy.
Exactly. He's not mad at you about it.
Why are you so no trusty when you are the only one in here who we know don't know as long as we know each other?
Because
we were all in a car together.
So you
even Jim here, we know him longer than we have known you.
You knew him for 30 minutes longer than you met, and then you met
me. That was a long car.
Okay, I'm gonna get it out and I'm gonna check and see if we have a flat.
Okay, cool. You do that and then we will plot against you.
As you exit outside what? Into the desert heat, it's extremely hot, late afternoon. The sun's blaring down and you notice the back right tire is completely flat.
Oh no. You know what? No. We're supposed to wear these fur coats.
I'm not wearing that.
It shields us or something.
From the sun?
No, it shields us from the Psyods.
we are, so- okay. I just,
you know,
we
yeah,
have a so his dog can't see us.
Okay.
Why does he think his dog is mad at us?
I have no idea. What did you do to the dog?
I didn't do anything to the dog. I just need to take care of this flat right now. Can someone check in the back and see if we have, who's in the back? Jim?
Jason?
James?
Is there a tire back there?
He opens the side thing and you look up and see him and he's completely white and sweating.
Oh.
Yeah, okay. Yeah.
Never mind, just lay down, honey. Just lay down, it's okay. Never mind.
I don't really want to lay down.
Okay. Why don't you drink some water or eat something?
Can someone bring me water?
Yeah.
There's no water.
Someone other than Goldstein bring me water?
Yeah.
We don't have water, we only have Search.
Oh God, that's like fine. Radioactive.
Okay. Wait, why did we don't have water?
Nope, the fridge only has Search.
Did someone try the faucet?
Is there water in the faucet?
Why are you drinking RV water, huh?
Do you know
how long have this RV been sitting around? You're just gonna sip the water? Also, what if I need that water for a shower? What if I need that water if I need to take a shit, huh?
DK, can you please give the dying man some water?
I will give
him a
drink.
I'm dying?
No, I'm dying?
No, you're like
Do you know something I don't? I don't feel good.
No, we don't know anything, but you look like death.
Yeah,
but
you're kind of guessing here.
Your face looks like...
It's literally just a shot in the dark.
Like evil intellect.
Mm-hmm. That's it, or with my
D12? With the D12.
4 and 2, 4 is my luck.
4 is your luck?
Mm-hmm.
As he's saying that, you kind of look towards the back, and you see even through some of the paneling in the RV, even though you can't see him, the kind of glow from inside him of his tumor kind of spreading out as you can feel the spread going through his body, and you can tell that he's definitely dying.
He's dying.
What?
Yeah,
what?
Don't
what?
No.
I can see it.
Oh
can
my
see
god.
Dying, dude. My bad.
And you're
you
bad?
Give him sink water.
You're bad.
Well, hold on.
Why can't we go to a hospital?
Let me get out of the RV. I'll just take a walk. Take a walk.
He's not going anywhere.
Why don't you take a walk? I think you're the one killing me.
I don't have a shirt on.
You have a fur coat.
All right.
I didn't get one.
I'll take a walk.
Where are you gonna go?
I don't know.
Maybe you could help Noah replace the tire.
Yeah, Jay.
Let's do it.
Let's do it.
Just do it. I'm down.
It's okay.
Walk turned into changing the tire.
Okay, I want everyone to, just a quick reminder to everyone, to everything that was said in the vehicle. This RV is protecting Syats from scanning us. Most likely that big wolf that I am going to assume either gave Noah a bloody nose or she has a coke problem.
I do not have a coke problem.
You and the wolf were gone for a very long time, and I was like, oh, she's
and
out
we
there.
We were snorting lines together.
I was like, oh, she's petting the wolf. I want to pet the wolf.
No, Jay, we are going to the back of the car, and we're gonna see if there's a tire back there. Please, God, let there be a tire.
We go to the back.
As you go to the back, you hear Jason as you kind of run to the other side of the RV, and he's now in the very front, like just sweating up in the front of the RV as you make your way to the back. As you guys make your way around to the back, you notice kind of a service hatch on the very back of the RV. As you open it up, there is a large tire inside and tire iron and jack. Yes. What do you do next?
You know what to do with this, right, Jay?
Yeah, kind
of. Okay, well.
Can you roll intellect for me? And can you roll intellect for me?
With the D12?
Yes.
Is it with the?
2 and 7, 8, 9.
Wait, where's mine?
Your
D12?
You have your
D12?
And your intellect?
You need to roll twice. You only have one.
Too smart. Oh. Yikes. And a five.
Okay. You're lying.
All right.
You have no idea what you're doing. And you know he's lying because you can see that he's lying.
So this is easy. You just take out this...
You're lying.
Huh?
Why would you lie? You know that I can read your mind.
All the time?
Yes.
Damn. well,
oh
I don't
God.
Know. I'm always feel so useless. I thought I could figure
okay,
it out.
Okay, just pull the tire out then.
It's heavy.
You have a six
help
pack.
Me. I know, but that's
fine,
just
fine.
You.
Okay, on, fine. Help I'll me. Help you. God.
You gotta, why are you up in my stuff?
What do you mean up in your stuff?
You just have like my debt.
What's wrong with me?
That sounds like a personal problem.
It is.
Jim comes from around the corner with his arm wrapped up. Nobody else inside seemed to want to help, so.
What, are you bleeding? What were you guys doing back there?
You didn't just like turn around and see me cleaning blood off for the last.
No, I thought you guys were just playing games
or
something.
10 and 2.
I was watching the road.
Oh yeah.
Not in this conversation. I have a one-armed man and a dude that can't, oh my God. Okay, well.
Look, I'm not gonna be much help right now, but just.
Tell me what to do. I'll do it.
First, loosen the lug nuts.
Which ones are those?
Noah, can you take that wrench there? I think you're far more capable than he is to do this.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Yeah, well.
I do.
But you just love this. Just love watching a woman work.
Would you rather me have said that I think he's more capable
than you? I meant James.
So,
I said I would help. I just didn't know what was. If you could help educate me, I think I would be far better off. But you guys just want to sit around and make fun.
Those are lug nuts.
Now I know.
I don't know. Why don't you go watch like a YouTube video of it? Maybe DIY or something.
That's a pretty good idea. That's how I learned.
Okay.
But
I want to help.
Loosen those. Well, if you want to help, grab the jack once it's loose.
Which one is that?
It's the thing in the back there that looks kind of like a cylinder.
That one.
Yeah, with the cylinder kind of thing. Put that under the back.
Got it.
Under the that metal part, but don't put it on the body. You're gonna want to put it directly on the frame. Don't put it under the leaf spring or
the what?
Put it on the solid metal part.
Just
right.
Point at
the
it.
The solid metal.
Okay, got it. Got it.
Everyone. So I noticed you are changing the dia. And you're getting ready to jack the RV. Do you want us to get out?
No, you're fine.
Should we get out?
Are they fine?
They're fine.
Okay.
Okay.
It's not gonna fly off the face of the earth because we're changing the tires.
Wait, DK, why don't you offer to help? You just walked out
apparently
here and you're gonna go back
inside? Apparently he's afraid to come outside because you gotta stay inside.
Exactly.
So when
you guys
are crazy wolf.
Yeah, yeah, when you're getting eaten up by a wolf,
right?
When you hear that engine roar, that is us leaving. Because you guys are so smart.
I don't know, we have a couple of hours. Can I do anything to help?
You're fine.
Come inside with me and be safe.
Okay.
Thank you.
Yeah, go inside. All right, so now I got it up. Just take the tire, put it on, tighten the lug nuts in a star pattern, remove the jack, and we're good to go.
Hey, what are you guys doing?
Changing the tires.
Watching Jay change the tire.
Ooh,
can
I want to watch.
Help me take the tire off.
Karen.
Help me take the tire off.
Why are you outside the RV when you hurt the man? I know you believe this with me. You believe these Sayat activity. Why are you outside with them?
I'm bored.
I know. I'm bored too. That's why when we get in Vegas, I'm going to get as sat as I've got done.
Wait. What?
What?
I'm going to get a Settlers of Catan.
You're getting a Settlers?
Settlers of Catan.
I love the game!
Settlers of Catan, yes. See?
They have board games in Vegas?
Yes.
We
just killed a bunch of people, and we're supposed to go to Vegas to meet some code name weird business lady, and you're talking about fucking board games?
Yes. How do you expect us to keep human and
just
sane?
Just like that.
Oh, well, I don't know. Apparently you guys are the furthest thing from human right now, and you're trying to act like this is all fucking
normal.
Don't
put your jealousy on me because you don't...
I'm not jealous. We just killed a bunch of people, and we're told to watch out for some crazy... This is some screwed up shit.
Don't you say we, okay? I killed one person, and Jay Goldstein killed so many.
Stunned.
Jay Goldstein killed everyone. And I get one. You did nothing, okay? You watched us save your life. That's what you did. So don't you come and try and be Mr. Bossman.
I also didn't kill anyone.
Okay, all right, well maybe we should have left you back there.
Regardless, I'm with you now. I'm an accomplice to all this. And
accomplice.
I think you got it.
It sounds like somebody was going to call the cops with the language you are using.
As you say that, you see a police car driving up about 200 yards behind the vehicle, little lights as it pulls over.
Help is here.
Cheat.
Oh no, that's not how this works at all, honey.
Just keep your mouth shut.
Don't worry, I got this.
Okay, don't worry.
I got it.
Jay does not have it.
Don't worry, I dealt with a lot of cops.
You don't have it either.
You're not wearing a shirt.
And I'm glistening with sweat.
All right.
Let's hope he's gay.
No. Karen, let's go inside the RV.
What?
Yeah, we're gonna, me and DK are gonna go inside the RV.
We're gonna find a gay cop outside, 200, 300 miles outside of Vegas.
Well, you never know.
Weirder things have happened.
Let me handle it.
Oh my God.
All right, have fun making best friends with a cop.
Yep, we're going to be inside.
Police officer, as you're saying, that kind of closes the door and is walking towards you guys as you kind of meet him halfway. You notice he is a very young police officer, like a young Asian man, and Officer Hammond is on his nameplate. He walks up with a very friendly approach. He's not like holding his gun or anything like that. You folks run into some trouble?
Yeah, we, our tires just blew out, man. How you doing?
I'm good.
Great.
Yourself?
Well, we got it fixed, and we're on our way out. Going to Vegas, man.
Vegas?
Yeah.
That guy okay? He's bleeding.
Oh!
Blood on his arm.
Tattoo. The healing.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Yeah.
Everything's good, man.
Yeah. You Vegas!
How long you been a cop?
Do you all need, I mean, it's really hot out here and you look like you might need some help. I just...
Oh no, I'm sure you have parking tickets and traffic tickets to write and stuff out
no,
here.
No, there's not a problem out here. There's no...
Are you? Talk to the cops.
Are you okay,
Never
sir?
Never talk to the cops.
Yeah, I'm fine.
Stop.
You okay, sir?
Do not peacock this man. He's not...
Peacock?
Mm-mm. Ma'am, what's peacock?
It's nothing. We're on our way to Vegas.
What's peacock? I mean, you all are acting rather strange. Are you okay?
No, it's just my first time.
You guys didn't come out here to do some weird desert, you know, find yourself... LSD kind of stuff.
I already found myself, sir. No, I'm great.
You guys aren't doing drugs out here, right?
No, we're straight edge.
No, you guys don't have any drugs?
We don't. We got a lot of surge.
Just the drug of love, right, honey?
I love you so much.
Yeah, I'm gonna need to search the vehicle.
Oh, why? I think you actually need a warrant for that.
Are we in trouble?
I have no idea. He's right.
Yes.
You would need a warrant.
Yeah, man.
A warrant?
Yeah. You can't just search a vehicle, man.
Your vehicle's parked on the side of the road.
Yeah, but that doesn't mean you can search the vehicle.
You're right, I could get it towed instead.
We don't need a tow.
I think all he needs is probable cause.
We're good.
You're good?
He definitely is.
That man's bleeding.
Tattoo, it takes a while to heal.
You're apparently trying to peacock me or whatever that is, and I have reason to believe you all might be on drugs.
Give me a breathalyzer.
You're volunteering for a breath?
Yeah, give me a breathalyzer.
You seem rather confident that I won't find any drugs in your system for something that tests only for alcohol.
Right. Let's do it. I'm ready. I'll take one for the team.
Sure, why don't you come on back to the car with me?
Let's do it.
So I'm just gonna need you to sit here if you don't mind, sir. And go ahead and have a seat.
All right.
And he shuts the door on you and walks away.
Hey!
Now, is there someone else I can talk to who's not apparently trying to peacock me or something?
Yeah, yes, yes.
Whatever
sir,
that
I'm,
means.
Yes. I'm here. I can talk to you.
Can you just tell me straight up what's the problem? I'm here to help. Look, I'm not gonna arrest you.
We're just some friends that are on our way to Vegas. We're excited. It's my first time. I've never been before. And I'm excited.
I know that man's not your husband.
No.
She is right. That wasn't her husband. Because I am her husband. Me.
Honey.
Yes. So how can we help you, officer?
Yeah.
How can we help you?
Ma'am, is this boy bothering you?
What?
Whoa!
Who is a boy? Who is a boy?
Sir, calm down. Sir, you look like you're about 16 years old.
It's the genetics. He's not.
I meant that as a race thing.
Oh, no. I know you meant it as a race thing.
No, this is a misunderstanding. You look like you're about 16.
I will see.
And this woman's clearly 35.
I'm not 35. Is it the tight?
I'm just saying, man, you're obviously twice this individual's age.
I am not twice his age.
This on my cell phone.
We could be married.
This is on my cell phone. I hope you know you are now on my cell phone. And I will upload it.
No, officer, it's okay. It's totally fine.
How many people are inside this RV?
It's just friends.
It's okay.
And you're not on some desert.
No, it's okay. That's not her husband. Because I am her wife.
Babe, you don't have to tell him that. Okay, we didn't know. I know that this is like the South. And so we didn't know how accepting you'd be here.
I'm an Asian American living outside of Reno.
Okay.
And this is not the South. This is very far.
Well, I consider this area like desert.
Prostitution's legal just over there.
It's okay. Like South adjacent though. Can we?
We'll just tell him. We're going to get married.
Yes, we are going to get
married. We're not officially married yet.
In defiance of our families.
Yes.
Well, I mean, I'm ordained if you want to do it right here.
We would need to get a marriage license first, and then there's a waiting period.
I don't know if I wanted to get married in the middle of nowhere.
Look, I know, Mr. Officer, we would love to, but these two, they keep talking about how they want it to be done by an Elvis impersonator.
I'm a big Elvis.
Guys, what's going on out there? I see a police officer. What's going on out there?
No, why would you even...
Guys?
Why would you even open your mouth? Why would you... You see a cop and you that's your first... That's
oh, is
that's
he here to help us?
We fixed the flat.
Guys, I thought you said I was dying.
Starvation. We're gonna get food.
You're dying to go to Vegas and watch us get married.
Right. Dying from the weight.
Sir, can you step out of the RV, please? It appears anyone else that's inside the RV, please just step outside.
I better do what he says.
No, you don't have to.
Hi.
Yes, ma'am, are these your parents? By any chance? Is this your mother?
I'm not older.
You look like you would need to be under some sort of supervision.
No, I'm
Are
a
any
grown
of
up.
These people your relatives or guardians?
I'm a grown up.
Other individual, do you mind stepping out? As you see Jason kind of hunkered over, stepping out completely white and sweating. Hi, officer, I'm dying. What is...
Okay,
I got it.
I will clear this up. I promise, here's what's happening, and it is the truth.
As you say that, you start hearing the sound of the ID coming from Karen's pocket, beginning to speak from inside of her pocket.
Oh, no.
Hi!
Okay. What the fuck is that?
No, just...
What's inside...
No, it's just one of those, you know, the tablet, PC tablet.
What's inside your shirt, ma'am?
You know, Karen. Like one note.
What's inside your shirt, ma'am?
No, it's...
Ma'am, what is inside your shirt?
Karen. Voice recorder. Hi! Karen.
Hi!
See, it's me.
Hey, you guys. How's it going? What's happening? Why is this officer here? Are you here to help? Oh, hi.
Remember like those top boys, you know, from like Home Alone?
Yeah, just like records things that mm-hmm. she had said earlier. No, I didn't. I'm my own person.
You're...
I'm technology, right?
It's so crazy. It's like a Furby. Or like those little things that hatch from the eggs.
What is a Furby?
The tire's good. Tire's good, right? He's walking back and looking at you all and kind of nodding, and he just kind of reaches back and opens the door that Jay's in, and you step out and just kind of shuts it, and he just never takes his eyes off you and continues nodding, and And it gets in the car, is like, oh, you all have a good day! And he
Bye,
hops
officer.
In and he drives
Bye.
Off quickly.
I'm only 27!
He can't hear you.
We gotta get the fuck out of here.
Yeah,
we
need guys? To leave.
Cops are scary.
What?
Yes, they are, Doc. Guys, yes, they are.
He was... What? If he was trying to help, why didn't you have him take me to a hospital?
Why can't we go to hospitals?
Oh.
I need help.
We're almost there. We're almost to the city. We just fixed a tire.
Okay.
We're gonna get.
Do you think it's weird that we're all wearing these clothes?
Jessam brings up a good point. We all fell apart because we didn't have a plan. We all tried to improvise. It blew up in our faces.
No,
I don't know what to say. I don't
that was
look
pretty
like
goddamn
mom.
Hilarious, if I do say so myself. Well, you guys are an absolute shit show.
Well, what are we? We need our plan
What's
now.
What's a shit show?
We need our plan now. What are we gonna do to Vega? Jason, I will take you to the hospital. You'll be my drunk friend from college, and that's our excuse we'll use. Stick to it, okay?
I'm a drunk friend from college.
Yes, and I'm taking you in, and you're probably gonna feel better once you're away from him. But we'll still get you checked out because we gotta find out if it's you or if it's him.
Oh, okay.
Lily,
and then
you guys
go gamble, make us some money, do it quick. You know we can only be out short bus, so I'd say in 1 hour intervals, we'll go gamble, get some money, and then we hitch it, and we go straight for Utah. It's just going to sound like that, Utah. Okay, you know what I'm
where?
Saying.
What do I do?
What?
Utah, Salt Lake, you see?
What? You?
Salt Lake
U-turn?
City? Salt Lake City,
Salt
Utah.
Lake. What? Why are we going to Salt Lake?
Just to keep driving. Didn't you hear?
We have to find that
but why? No, we just got to stay in the RV.
Yeah, but he also
if we
said
stay in
drive.
The RV, we're fine, and
we don't know that.
But
just
it shields
yet.
Us, right? So we can just get out of the RV, but it use our mind powers, someone, and get all the money we
if
need.
If someone is following us, then they will just keep going this way and run into us.
You think
us.
Someone's following us?
Yes, he said it in the video. Was I the only one watching the video?
Wait, we're also supposed to go and find that Gen 2 cold or whatever back
in
Vegas.
Oh, yes.
Yeah,
okay, so we need a gamble team and we need a Ginny 2 cold team. So, obviously, Noah, you're going to be on the gamble team with...
No.
With Garen. Garen.
Yeah.
No, and Garen, you guys
Vegas,
go.
Vegas.
Jay Goldstein, no, because
I play blackjack better than anybody.
Okay, you know.
You are
and with
not
her powers,
I promise you,
I'm
you are going
dude.
To goof it up. You know what, if you want to do it?
No.
Nope. What?
No.
What?
No. Only people with shirts get to go gamble
right.
today.
I mean,
no
he's got
shirt,
a
no
fur
shoes,
coat
no.
in that.
No.
RV.
I mean, he's probably not going to
And we're supposed to be wearing those when, I mean, you guys.
Don't you see I am wearing?
We are. I think it freaked the cop out.
Yeah, so we got to get moving.
Well, I mean,
so that's
still
You can
shirtless.
Have mine. I'm not going to wear it.
I don't, the video said we should wear it.
I don't care
I mean,
about that
it
guy.
Says, it says Noah Castillo on it.
Yeah, well.
Whatever. If you don't want to wear it, Jason.
It's Castillo.
You get to wear it.
Castillo, right?
Jason, you
Castillo?
Wear it.
Castillo? What?
The double
C-A-S-T-I-L-L-O?
The double L,
Castillo?
Yeah.
Castillo.
Why you smell like there's a Y in there?
That's how you...
You keep talking
Where
and you're
you
not gonna
from?
Get a coat.
You know what, yeah, I think I'd rather keep my coat.
Oh, okay.
All right, we've done enough talking. We need to get back on here and we need to go. Okay?
All right, let's go.
I don't wanna stay here anymore.
Let's go.
We done, everyone? Everyone yes. pee, everyone... bleed out or whatever they need to do. Everyone
we will do that
done?
In the RV. Yeah.
Okay.
Let's go. Maybe
back.
I will drive now. It seems like driving for you.
Do you guys do the star
Can
pattern
you even have
on
your driver's
the lug
license?
Nuts?
Yes.
Star pattern on the lug nuts. We good?
I don't know.
Can
They're
just,
tight.
Can you just double check?
Well, just
like
make sure you
check.
Do a star pattern and then we need to lower it and then make sure they're tight so you get more torque on your turn.
Well, we have to lower it then.
Well,
so you guys continue working together to get through that. As you go back
here.
Onto the RV, Jason makes his way to the very back, kind of sectioning himself off into the back again. As you ever once in a while, you hear him.
That's not the right way.
As you get back in, you start hearing Jason coughing from the back as you start driving again down the road, heading towards Vegas.
I'll go up and talk to Noah. Look,
I know this is hard for you. What, did you have some kind of boyfriend or something you had to leave behind? Something, some kind of important job? Why are you so, high strung? We are all younger than you, but you seem more worried.
You're not that younger than me. Why does everyone keep saying that?
I'm 18. You can drink. That's a huge difference. I mean, but
I thought you said you were 19.
That's what I mean.
Are you actually 18?
No, I am 19.
Are you 18 and you're telling people you're 19?
I am 19, okay?
Why are you acting like you're 19 when you're 18?
I'm 19, okay?
It's like the same thing.
Because thank you. It's like the same thing. Thank you, Noah. It's like the same thing.
It's like the same thing. Then why can't you just say you're 18?
Because I'm 19, okay? Goodness gracious.
You can drink in Canada at 19. You can't at 18.
Ah, that's weird. So... What, talk to us. What is your deal, huh?
What do you mean, what's my deal?
What's special to you?
We're all special. We're special. Why are you asking me these questions?
You kept talking about what was gonna happen to us wasn't what was supposed to happen and...
Well, that definitely wasn't supposed to happen. All those bodies?
What?
A bunch of people dying?
What was supposed to happen?
I don't know. I don't know the plan anymore.
In your mind's eye, what is the ideal thing to have happen?
Not being stuck on this RV with everybody.
All right. What do you want?
I just want us to get to civilization.
What is in civilization?
A phone. That works.
So who are you going to call?
I don't know.
Is it this Solomon?
I mean a phone that works. His is right there. He's been using it.
Yeah.
For GPS.
But does it, wait, you can have you called anyone? Why haven't you called anybody?
Because I was using GPS. Why would I call people? What am I going to tell them? Hey, I can't come to you anymore because I am a superhero.
But
we could call an ambulance.
Why are you trying to do? We are not going to call an ambulance. What do you think?
There's a guy dying in the back.
Okay. Also, you gotta stop.
What are you gonna say?
A cartoon did it?
They're not. An ambulance doesn't ask you if you were in a fucking knife fight. They don't care.
Do you have health insurance? Who's going to pay for that ambulance?
I mean, that's maybe he's got. They don't ask you for cash up front when you call
the ambulance. But who you think pays for it? The taxpayers?
It does end up being like $1,000.
You're going to let a guy die because you're worried about taxpayers paying for an ambulance?
No, I'm going to let a guy die because I don't want to go to the hospital.
You don't have to go to...
Guys. My butt still really hurts from that time that I fell.
Oh, sorry. Wait. Can you tell the little me to not talk to authority figures?
Did you hear that? I mean, okay. I understand and respect your opinion.
Aw,
you're cute.
Is there a reason you're keeping that thing around? I mean, it's obviously not going to
pass. Yeah, is there a reason that we have not redrawn Stickum yet?
I don't know, man. She's just kind of nice. Okay. I just like being around nice people sometimes. Because y'all are the worst.
Oh, okay.
You're the one who refuses to go to the hospital. We've got a dead guy and a bleeding guy.
It was your idea to...
A dead guy?
I mean, like, so soon.
Well, he's dying.
He's gonna be dead, like,
that's part
so
of
soon.
My plan.
Did
we already forget my plan? I'm taking him to the hospital. You and Noah are on the Gambit crew, and Jay and Dot are going to find this cold woman.
Can you just check and see how far away we are?
You're now 100 miles away.
I feel like we could probably stop for a burger.
Where?
At the mini off. Did you think we were driving for 100 miles and couldn't get off the freeway once?
You have the map. You have all
you
the
have
locations.
The eyes, though. Tell me.
I'm just trying to get there. I thought you could eat your ramen.
Yeah, but I'd like it up here with you. Maybe get a burger.
I pull out my phone and check my Twitter.
Do you think they're still following us on our phones?
Yeah, I got a bunch of followers.
Oh, God.
Wait, can you... Hey, I know DK up there doesn't seem to want to help Jason in the back, but, like, I think you have something to do with him being sick, you know, like...
Yeah, I do.
Do you think you should, like, call for help to, like, meet us halfway so he gets to where he, like, help sooner? Because it sounds like the longer he's in here with us, the worse he gets because of you. Like, if DK's not going to call, you got a phone, like, call an ambulance.
Hey, what you guys talking about back here, huh?
Nothing that apparently concerns you.
Oh, okay, okay. You know I can make my hand so heavy that I crush your skull, right?
Whoa.
Because I am real tired of you seeing back here and trying to undermine me when you have no powers. You do not even understand what is going on in our heads right now. You
look, I may not have powers, but there is a guy dying.
Yeah, but you don't know what's
at stake.
For one guy,
hello,
you're going to raise. Oh.
What? Who are you calling?
Calling in.
What?
I'm not gonna let Jason die, okay?
I smack your phone.
I need you to roll for that. can you roll your action for me?
With the
D12.
Two.
That is a two, which is my lucky number, you motherfucker.
So he hits the phone out of your hand as it goes flying into the back, and because it was a critical hit, it hits the wall and smashes into a couple pieces.
Oh!
We will go to the doctor according to the plan. We can't risk all of us getting caught right now. Do you not understand that?
What do you mean we can't be caught? What are you even talking about?
Did you not watch the video? He said we are being chased. We have already...
How does an ambulance picking somebody up have to do with us being
Hello?
Chased?
Did you not hear?
Hey, I need an ambulance.
He does have two phones on his sheet.
Yeah. You're just 100 miles out of Las Vegas.
What are you doing?
Yeah, can you meet us halfway?
No, I'm gonna...
Tell them the highway we're on and let's have them meet us, yeah.
No, okay. I stop the car and I get out to smack the phone out of his hand.
You smack the phone out
yes.
of his hand.
Yes.
But this time I dodge it.
Can you both roll an action for me?
Would it be 12 or no?
No, just your two actions. You guys are, you're basically.
This is mine.
Just your action.
Wait, is this mine? Yeah. There's this?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
No.
Seven.
Three.
So you go to slap the phone and he steps back and moves out of the way and continues talking and starts describing the Winnebago and the license plate number as he's running away from you around the back of the van.
You're such an idiot! I said you're not supposed to bring anyone here!
No, it's just my girlfriend. Don't worry about
that. Oh my god!
You know what?
He's really angry.
Now, I don't understand. Why are you guys so...
We're not supposed to get, like, government people involved in this.
Yeah.
It's an ambulance.
What do you mean it's an ambulance? Do you not know it's still connected to the government? Or are you lost on that?
You turn GPS on your phone.
Yeah, that is fine. Because
how is turning GPS on your
phone
fine?
Because we are moving.
They're tracking our phones, and you're not worried about that?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, because we need to get somewhere. That is an important thing for our group.
So it's okay if you turn on the GPS on your phone, but if somebody wants to proactively try to save another person's life, it's a
and
problem
risk
for
it
you.
All? Because did you, not see? Because
you didn't ask anybody.
I said we will save him when we get to the city. But if you want to do it now, let's call it. Let's call it. And I swear to you, if anything happens where we are at risk, I will kill you myself. And
you
I swear,
put it.
I promise
what
you,
is with your thing
you,
with killing? Oh, I kill this guy. I'm going to kill this guy. I'm going to make my hand grow heavy.
Because you guys don't understand the gravity of this. So maybe if I crush his head, you will learn it.
Ha.
Cool. So the ambulance is on its way.
Okay.
Where is it even coming from?
I don't know.
You just call 911?
Yeah.
Yep.
We're 100 miles from anywhere. Do we have to wait?
No, we're not waiting. I get back in, I start the car back up. We're going.
Do you think they can help him?
I hope so.
Who put any of you guys in charge? What is happening right now?
What's happening is we're doing the best we can with what we have. As much as I don't trust her, at this time, at this moment, I stand ignore.
I'm not okay with letting somebody die.
You don't
so,
know. Are you a doctor? You haven't even taken a class in college to become a doctor, but like now death. You are the master of sciences,
and Jay
huh?
said it looks like he's dying, and apparently he's connected to this.
We are all dying. Have you ever considered that?
Well.
All right. If you want to be like that, you told him where we were, right?
Yeah.
Why don't you call him back and tell him that you can find us at this spot? I'll stay here.
What? They'll find you.
Leave Jason with me.
They'll find you.
That's fine. I'm not going to let this guy die to protect my own ass.
Okay.
We'll I mean, if you want to stay, we can't
no,
stop.
No, no, yeah. We'll leave him, and here is my cell phone.
No.
No, no.
But
here is my cell phone.
The one that's possibly being tracked, that you didn't ask for
anyone's
permission.
Oh, now you are afraid of being tracked. Here's my cell phone. And make sure you call me and let me know exactly what happens. I want to hear
I can't
the
call
last...
you if you give
no,
me your cell
this
phone.
Guy,
then we don't have
this
another...
guy has his phone.
I
didn't you remember when he pulled it out right in the middle of my great speech?
I don't think we should split up.
No,
Are we headed towards a... the city now?
Yes, we're headed towards the city right now.
But it,
Liz
this
can
seems,
wait 50 more miles.
Apparently they can't. So if they want to wait here, I give them a cell phone. It has GPS. It's well charged. So they can wait right here for the police. Or they can stick to my plan and get taken to a hospital first class with me. I was going to walk him in there myself. But since you are so smart.
How is you walking into a hospital somehow safer than an ambulance picking up
because
a guy
I know
off the
my
side
exits.
Of the road?
When you get in the back of that ambulance, how are you going to get out if something goes wrong?
I feel like you got some control issues, man. Just leave Jason with me. I'll watch him and make sure that he gets taken care of. And it seems like just getting away from Jay will help. So just we'll be fine.
Okay.
If they're on their way, I mean, you call 911. What's the longest it's going to take someone to get here? 20 minutes? Like in the max?
Okay.
Be fine.
Here you go. Here's my cell phone.
Takes his phone coats. From you, flips you off as he starts grabbing other stuff from you.
You should take this coat.
Which coat is it? Is it your coat? So he puts on your coat and he's like, thanks. So as you're kind of handing him stuff and you walk Jason out of the RV and he's looking extremely sick and just...
Sorry, man.
I'll be fine. I'm unbreakable, remember? I'll be fine.
Yeah.
I can't be hurt. I'll be fine.
Just go, man, go.
And there's kind of, you see Jim kind of put the coat around Jason, and as he's leaving, he's like, I don't think we were supposed to be a part of your group anyway. Be
no,
fine.
You weren't.
And just starts to sit there, and as you guys all kind of pile back in, and the sun starts to go down, as nightfall hits and you're driving away. As you're driving away, you start to see this light emitting from where you drop them off, and the further you drive, the brighter the light seems to get.
What is that?
What is that?
Call me.
It's ringing.
Nobody picks up.
Turn around, something's
no.
wrong. I'm not.
No, we can't
turn
around. Risk it. Look, I want to clarify something. I'm not this Mr. Crazy guy and all this, but you know what's at stake. You saw what happened in the bunker. I would do anything to prevent that happening again. So if that means we have to leave someone behind because they don't want to stick together, we have to move together as a plan. You heard everything. The one constant among everything that was taught to us by whoever the fuck Noah was working for, by Dumoku, it's all been that people are trying to capture us and people are trying to take advantage of us. And we've seen proof of that. So we got to be smart. We can't just be trusting anyone because you and I know what the government looks like, and did it not look like those soldiers that were shooting right outside the bunker? We don't know what we got into, so we gotta be smart. And we can't just call any ambulance and have some record of us.
As you continue driving down the highway, you continue to see this light that's just glowing from the location you leave behind as it gets smaller and smaller and smaller in your rear view. A couple miles later, an ambulance with the lights on drives past you as they kind of flash inside the vehicle and you continue on towards Vegas. There's now kind of a silence that comes back to the RV, similar to when we began, as you sort of crest the hill, driving into Vegas, seeing it in the distance.
Vegas.
Just a small town girl.
I won 200 grand at Vegas one time.
What?
What?
Yeah.
I have stopped believing anything you've ever said.
Don't stop believing.
The God damn it.
No, it's real. It's real.
I walked right into that one. I can't even believe it.
I was playing blackjack, and it just kept coming, man. I just kept beating the dealer, card after card. They kicked me out.
What happened to all that money?
Spent.
On what?
What did you spend all that money on?
Oh man, trips. I spent it on girls. Spent it on cars. I had 3 cars.
Noah, can you roll intellect for me?
Six.
You can tell that he's actually telling the truth, but you don't tell anyone that you can tell that he's telling the truth.
Okay. I mean, I tried to do some good with it, but I don't know, man. I didn't know what I was doing with my money. Money seems to just fall in my lap and then fall right back out again. I've lived a good life.
You begin making your way into the city, hitting the main strip as the lights begin to flash around you. You notice that the gas tank is getting close to empty, and the casino that you don't know you're supposed to go to because the tape got messed up before it got to that part is somewhere in this town, but you know you're supposed to be looking for an individual named Jin Below Zero.
Oh, thank God, a gas station. All right, I'm gonna pull, Dot, do you have that $10?
Yeah, yeah.
Perfect. I'm gonna pull over in here. Everyone just stay inside, okay?
Okay, no, I don't wanna blow your spot or anything like that, but like 28 years old, right?
Right.
You don't have no money? You gotta take $10 from, you know, Dot?
My stuff was confiscated in the bunker, just like yours.
Okay. I wasn't trying to blow your spot.
No, it seemed like you were trying to blow my spot.
Oh, no, I was trying to pull you to the side.
It was very spot-blowing. Okay. What does that mean? I'm going to go inside, and I'm going to get some gas. You guys are all going to stay inside, right? Okay. Jay, why are you smiling?
No, we're in.
Karen, can you make sure that everyone stays inside?
Sure. That seems like something that's a job for Karen. And not DK.
I don't mean to blow your spot or anything. But you have your second cell phone. You're internet famous. You probably could Apple Pay. You know, you probably got Apple Pay. Probably got Apple Pay, right? You probably got a few bucks.
It's connected to my dad's card.
So that means you can use it?
No.
Why not? Why don't we, look, there's Arby's over there just across the street, you know. Aren't you in the mood for 2 roast beefs?
Me and no. You
munching on some roast beefs.
I can't use that. I can't use any of my dad's money. I can't do any of that.
Well, can someone let me borrow some money? I really want to go to the Arby's.
Why can't you use any of your dad's money?
Because I'll never hear the end of it. I'll never hear the end of it.
Do you go into the gas station?
I go into the gas station, shutting the RV door behind me.
As you go into the gas station, it is a small gas station right off the strip, and it's completely, all the windows are barred over. There's a large glass kind of framed window, the small little sliding slot where you would hand over the money. As you try to hand him the cash, the man looks down, sees the cash, and then kind of taps on the window and points to a sign that says Amex only.
What? That's like the opposite of every gas station. You only take American Express? How do you do business here? Only, is this like an only American Express cardholders can use your gas station?
I'm not the boss.
You're missing out on like a huge population of people that would need gas.
I just work here, ma'am.
Okay. I don't have American Express. Is there any way that you could, you know, just accept this?
Amex only.
Okay. How about this? I just need 5 of it, and you could keep the other 5.
Amex only, ma'am.
Yeah, no, I heard you, but I'm finding it really hard to believe that only American Express cardholders can use this gas station. Because my RV is, like, out of gas.
You got Amex? We take Amex.
Okay, okay, yep, okay. Thank you. Thanks. I'm gonna take my money back now. Thank you, sir.
Have a good day.
All right. No thanks to you. I'll go back in the RV. Does anyone have frickin' American Express?
What? What? Literally no one anywhere ever has American Express.
I know, those two.
I have it.
You have American Express?
I can't use it.
What? Why would you offer?
Why would you open your mouth?
You just asked if anybody had it. I have it, but I can't use it.
But let me guess, because it's your dad's account. Why would you open your mouth at such a time?
I'm trying to be honest with everybody.
Okay, I get the honesty, but now is not the time for it. Oh my goodness. I was like, here comes Jay. Jay Goldstein is going to save the day.
What about an American Express card?
Or a gas can? I wonder if I could draw a gas. I've never done it before, and I don't think I remember what they look like, but.
Yeah, because Stickum could stab.
No, he could gas. Yeah, the gas, you remember, like, it's like a tank and then has like a big hose kind of nozzle.
Okay,
the hose and a handle and a nozzle.
Okay, I need you to be way more specific than the handle nozzle.
Okay, it's like a gardening, okay.
So it is red?
Yes.
And it is almost like a rectangle, okay? It's like a
rectangle.
It's like a rectangle. And then there is a snout
like an elephant trunk.
Yeah.
Like an elephant trunk?
Yeah, and make sure you draw it full too. Make sure it looks like, you know, he has some fullness to him. So, because you
Why?
Know, because if he's empty, then he won't have gas.
Oh.
Okay, so I'm just gonna,
maybe a little.
Draw like liquid lines.
Should I write full gas tank or full?
Yeah, maybe.
Full of gas.
Yeah, okay.
Hopefully now make sure you get the liquid gas.
Because that it's the spot which would put the gas in the tank.
So it's kind of like this?
As you say that, go ahead and roll your power.
Just my power by
Power with a D12.
What did we do? I roll a 11.
As you say, just like this, all of a sudden, a little, like, you hear like a poop, and you see like a little whoosh, as this gas can hits the ground in front of you, and it's got two little eyes on the top of it next to the snout, and the snout is kind of out like this with a mouth on the end of it.
Hi, everybody, I'm a gas can.
No.
Y'all need some gas? I'm gas in the gas can.
Oh, God. What did I do?
Somebody needed some gas.
Let's get the gas.
Hey, little guy.
And his kind of trunk goes up and confetti starts shooting out.
Oh! I'm gas in the gas can.
That's not gas. Do you have gas in the
Y'all need some gas?
Yeah, we need some gas.
And starts shooting confetti all over outside of the gas station.
No.
You look inside and see the individual that's working there just kind of standing out and just kind of eating a candy bar.
It's not anything you haven't seen. It's Vegas.
Does it? Do you have any real gas inside
you? I got the gas can.
Okay, can we like-
Do it again!
Pretty fun.
Can you take your gas can and try and put him in, pour him
into the tank? Gas in the gas can.
Okay, so I'm gonna pick Gassy up. Hey, little-
Oh, that tickles! Why are you touching me?
Oh my god, okay, so
Oh my god, I actually missed Stickum.
So I start carefully taking gas of the gas can over to the gas pump. So I've never poured gas before. What's that?
You just stick that long, like the long black thing. You stick the
I hate you so much, DK.
Sorry, I you know.
Why are you sticking in me? Stop touching me!
You stick the long black thing inside the hole of the car.
How am I the oldest person here? I can't believe
it's
this.
Gassy's being a little squirmish, you guys, so I gotta be real careful.
Stick the long black thing in the hole of the car.
Oh, I hate you so much.
Stick the hose into...
You don't need some gas?
So I take Gassy's hose. Hey, sorry about this, little buddy. I put it inside the thing, still squirmy, and I start pouring.
As you start squeezing him, you see just more and more confetti coming out of the hole and pushing back out into the air.
I'm gassing the gas can!
Oh, God.
Oh,
Y'all want some gas? Ooh, and then start shooting more confetti up into the air.
I think I fucked up the gas tank.
I see a lot. I don't think a lot of it made it in. I think it's just jammed. I will pick it out and maybe someone will find where we can get some actual gas.
Can you roll your intellect for me?
My intellect?
Yeah.
Intellect is a D6. I rolled a 2.
No, a lot of confetti got in that gas tank.
Oh.
Uh-oh.
Huh.
So
probably should have known that was gonna happen.
Yeah, you get some more gas.
No, we don't. Can
no,
you
no.
Want some more gas? Some gas in the gas can. Woo!
So okay. So now we.
What's your name? I'm gas in the gas can.
I don't want to talk to you, Gassy. I do not want to talk to you, Gassy.
Hey, pick me back up! Pick me back up!
It's kind of my baby. So I go and then I pick him back up.
Huh? Take me over to that one.
Over to DK?
Ooh, DK! DK, no. I'm gassing the gas
so
can!
I'm gassing the gas can!
Keep him away from me. I do not like that one.
And starts blowing confetti into your face as a sting.
I'm gassing the gas can! Hi, DK!
You will exit my life. You will exit my life immediately.
Oh, so you like the one that stabs, but you don't like the glitter cannon?
The one who ruins the IV? We gotta fix the IV now. Now we have to find a mechanic to fix the IV.
He needs to smile more.
You're right, Gassy. He does need to smile more.
No, I don't need to smile.
What's your name? I'm Gassy the Gas Can.
And he points his snout over to Dot.
I'm Dot. Hey, Gassy.
Woo!
And starts blowing confetti all over you as well.
I'm sorry, guys. I'm just so tired. And we're broken down in the middle of Vegas. And we have no money, and the RV doesn't work, and I think our friends are dead, and we have to find a woman with a weird code name.
It sounds like she's broken and not actually happy.
That is a very astute observation, Gassy.
I'm Gassy the Gas Can.
Okay, here's the plan. We just
DK has a plan, everybody.
I swear, Gassy, I will kill you myself.
What do you swear? Swearing's bad.
DK, kill him.
I will move you from this earth right now.
You can't kill Gassy.
He's not even real.
Okay.
But I made him.
You'll make a lot of things.
Okay.
Like, we don't need him. He's also annoying and he ruined our RV.
Okay, new plan.
Yeah?
Jay and Noah will go and do the casino plan.
No, Jay and Noah are not doing anything.
Yes, you have to do it. You have to get us money. Or we'll be here with a talking gas can. It's up to you. You have to save us, remember? You remember your plans, what you want for us?
No,
you
no,
have
please.
To do it.
No,
you have to
no,
do
please.
It.
You have to
okay! do it. Stop! God. Okay. Jay and I will go.
Across the street is a casino. It's a small one, but it's across the street.
Okay, and I...
Will someone get him a shirt? Give him your
no shirt,
shirt then. No, I'm not going with him
I'm
without
not
a shirt.
Wearing a shirt.
He is wearing a shirt. They won't even let you in.
Don't put a shirt on. Live free.
I'm guessing. I've got my fur coat. I'll put that on.
Fine, put your fur coat on.
But I'm leaving it way open.
Want some gas?
No. You know, and he's probably gonna blend in. I mean, it's like
fine.
Pretty late in Vegas.
He has to give us a lucky spray of confetti.
Showering you with confetti.
Okay,
let's
so
do this.
What we'll do is we have to find a mechanic. We have to go. Can we talk to the guy inside and see if we can leave our car here? I'll go talk to him.
So you walk into the gas station.
Yes.
He continues, as you're walking up, you see him just continuing to eat his candy bar and follow you with his eyeline, never once looking back at the gas can that's spewing confetti.
Oh, so I walk in and I'm the big concern, huh? No matter where I go, you're gonna follow me with your eyes, huh? Yeah, that's what I thought. Keep that chocolate, that thick chocolate in your mouth and don't say anything, okay? Look.
You got Amex?
Actually, I forgot my Amex.
I just thought I'd tell you now before you start a whole conversation.
Oh, no, I'm not going to buy anything. Our car just broke down, so I just wanted to let you know we're going to find the nearest mechanic and come back.
So you are going to buy something from me?
Yeah, when we get the Amex.
No, I mean, you're asking to rent time.
Oh, rent time. You know what?
I'm not the boss.
Who is the boss?
So I can talk to him. He's not here. But if he finds out, I let somebody, you know, keep a pump locked up, lose money.
Well, I'm not gonna leave it in the pump, I'm gonna push it into a parking spot right there. Look.
Can you, give me that, talking gas can you got out there and we'll call it a deal.
Here's the deal. If I give
That's
you-
That's the deal. Amex only.
Karen, I got some good news and I got some bad news.
I hate you so much.
So
what?
We're going to be able to leave it here. But
okay.
He needs the talking gas can to entertain him. Which means...
That I can't go anywhere.
Exactly.
In fucking Vegas.
Exactly. So I'm going... I will push the... We'll just put it in neutral. Push the RV in a parking spot. And, you know, maybe you can hang out... just
really
in the general area.
Do you want to stay with me and the gas can and the weird gas station man?
I guess.
Okay, so no one's on Team Gold, so I'm just by myself. No one, you're not going to
How
go.
How are we going to find her?
We're just going to walk around and we're going to try.
Even I know that's a bad idea.
Good ideas are made out of bad ideas sometimes.
That's not a thing.
I promise you, I think Malcolm X
no,
said
No, that is definitely
sure
not
I,
really?
Yeah,
no.
I think Malcolm
no.
X said
Malcolm
by
X
any means
not,
necessary.
No.
He said by any means necessary, and sometimes good ideas are just bad ideas in hiding.
He definitely, Malcolm X never
look
said
up,
that.
I
don't
I think,
you need to believe.
This one.
No, you saw her gas plan, right? You saw what happened with that? Yeah, follow my plan. My plans haven't failed yet.
Can you mind find people? Is
oh,
that a
yeah,
thing?
Yeah, that's a whole thing, but we're using our mind thing to get money.
Yeah.
So we'll use yours, because here's the best thing. You come with me, something happens, say I get murdered, you get to turn to water and run back here.
No.
That doesn't make me excited about our plan.
Karen, should I go with him?
You know I need somebody for backup.
He does need someone for backup, and I do not trust him to do this without getting himself in trouble.
Diggy, I don't know how to do it.
Because he's a
anything.
Big
you
idiot.
You know that, right?
Yes.
Okay.
But I will teach you. Remember, I'm 19 years old.
Yeah.
All right, so what do you do? The two of you head across the street to the casino.
Can you just, put your, close it up a little bit? No, now your nipple, both your nipples are showing. Both your nipples are showing.
This is which one? Just let me do what I do, please. Okay?
And the two of you are
We are walking down the strip and trying to see if there's like.
Excuse me, are you Jim Below Zero?
We're just trying to party people.
The person you're yelling at doesn't look at you and just keeps walking. And
I don't think that's her.
And you're staying at the gas station.
I am at the gas station on the other side of the glass while that dude is hanging out with my gas can. He won't even let me inside the room.
So
I am on the other side of the bulletproof
glass. You see
the
individual on the other side who is now, he's taken the gas can and brought it in with him, sitting there eating a payday candy bar, just kind of chewing on it. Little grin on his face as he nods, as Gassy's on the other side. Just blowing confetti up into the air on the other side of the glass. I like your gas can.
Being a superhero fucking sucks.
So we cut to the casino as Jay walks in, chest out, with a strut as you follow behind him.
You didn't even hold the door open for me. What is wrong with you?
It's 2017, you got yourself.
I hate you.
He walked in. All right, my game is blackjack, right? But you can't read the other person's mind on that one because we're just flipping the cards. We need to get to a game where we can see other people and what they're looking at. Texas Hold'em. Let's find a table.
Fine.
So we walk in, I'm scanning the place for a Texas Hold'em. Do you see one?
Yeah, there are Texas Hold'ems kind of down on the floor on the opposite end. You see them kind of over there. You spot it and
all right,
train around.
Bingo, let's do it. Come on. All right, we walk over to the table.
Okay, I got to tell you something though. I've never gambled before, so I don't know. I don't know what I'm looking for.
Look, you just let me sit at the table, right?
Okay.
I'll do the gambling, you do the mind reading.
Yeah, but I don't know what I'm reading. Like, just what?
Tell me the cards.
Like right? What each person's card is?
Yeah. You'll have to tell me each person's card, whatever they got in their hands. They're gonna only have two hands.
How am I gonna tell you? They're gonna hear.
Just tap my back the number of times, however high their card number is. So if it's a seven, tap seven times on this side. If it's an ace, just poke me really hard.
What? I'm not gonna do that.
Why not?
Because you'll probably be into it.
I will, but just do it.
I could have gone with all right. Karen.
Oh, so I walk up to the table. What's going on, guys? I hope you're ready to lose.
Have a seat, sir.
All right.
As you sit down, everyone at the table looks over at you as your bare chest is kind of extruding out from your jacket that also has your name, Jay Goldston, on it, so.
Yeah.
Jay, thank you for joining us.
Great. Do you have those $10?
Oh, yes. Honey, here you go.
Thanks, babes. I'd like $10 worth of chips.
Everyone at the table just kind of looks at you. Okay, sir, I guess I will exchange that for you. Slides a chip across the table.
Thank you.
High stakes here. High stakes indeed.
But it only got you one chip?
Yeah. It's $10. We're in Vegas.
But I don't know how this works.
Okay.
I don't like gamble and stuff.
Sit back and relax.
Okay. Right. I am relaxed.
Okay, so as you begin playing, I'm gonna go ahead and have you roll your power for me.
Is this my?
Yeah, and it's gonna be just your power.
Okay.
Since you're using another individual.
Three.
So you are able to peer into his mind and see every card in his hand as you're playing, and you begin doing the kind of tap on his back as you win the first hand, and then you win the second hand, and you're now three hands in, and you've started to accumulate a little mass of chips in front of you. Everyone at the table is starting to get quite nervous. Is everything okay, sir?
Everything's great, man. What's wrong with you?
So you'd like to continue?
Absolutely. All in.
Great. Can you roll one more time for me?
Yeah.
Yeah, me. Your power, yeah.
Five.
And
that's your luck, too.
That's my luck.
Cool, so you see exactly how the hand's gonna play out as you win the entire hand and you start celebrating.
Babe, you got a hot hand! Oh, God.
You feel a hand placed on your shoulder. As you turn and look up, you see a very large individual wearing a black kind of suit and tie standing, hovering over you. Sir?
Is there a problem?
I'm gonna need you both to come with me.
Are we getting, like, is this because we won? We get, like, is this how it goes? Are they gonna give us, like, free dinner?
I'm not answering any questions. I need you to come with me.
I'm in the middle of the game, man.
We're on a lucky streak. Uh-huh.
Is this going to become a problem?
No.
I'd like to avoid any problems.
Let me just pick up all my chips.
Yeah. I'm going to just...
As you look over your shoulder, you notice seven other men standing in a half circle about 6 feet behind you.
Oh, no.
I'd really like to avoid problems.
No problem here, man.
No problems.
We're just having a good time.
As he takes a step back, you realize that his hand is actually on a pistol on his hip.
Okay.
I'm gonna need you to get up very slowly please.
I get up.
As you get up, all of the seven individuals take kind of a step back.
Just
move slowly.
Okay.
The both of you.
Okay.
We're gonna have no problems here.
No problems.
There's no problems, man. What's going on?
He looks past you to the individual at the table. Sorry to bother you, sir. We'll have this taken care of momentarily. Just come with us.
Have what taken care of?
Just please, come with us.
Where are we going?
We'll discuss this outside.
Why can't we do it here?
Outside, we're in a public place.
I don't think people would like to know of your current predicament in public. If you could please.
Our winnings?
We would like.
You could tell everybody. Tell us. Tell everybody right here. Sir, would you like to know? Sir, would you like to know? Everybody wants to know. What is this? What is this about? We're just a lovely couple trying to have a good time. It's been a long weekend, hasn't it, honey?
It's been a super long, we're just celebrating our anniversary.
Ma'am, the subjects are creating a problem.
We can hear.
I'd like to know how to proceed.
Who are you talking to?
I've been advised to ask you one more time. Can we not have a problem, please?
And I use my power to try and read your mind. To see where you're trying to take us and what you're trying to do.
Can you go ahead and roll for that, please?
Yeah. Five, which is also my luck.
Okay, so as you look into his mind, you see that he's extremely concerned that he might be hurt by the two of you. He's been advised to collect you for his boss, who is a woman that goes by the name of Jen, and that is all you were able to tell at this time.
Okay, I think maybe we should go with him.
Why are you pointing at me?
Can we
refrain from talking to each other?
Can we have a moment?
Can we discuss this outside?
It's a team effort.
Can we just discuss this outside?
I think
Let's go. We're creating a scene.
We're going.
We're going. Not
create
a scene.
Okay.
Stop. We're going.
Please.
Can I cash in my winnings? It's my first time I've ever gambled.
Please. We're very excited.
Ma'am,
knows Jim.
They'd like to
in that video,
cash in their
the guy
winnings.
That said, I don't even trust that guy. I don't know what to do, but that soul, the guy with the coat and the wolf.
Dr. Boog.
Yes.
Yeah.
I've been advised to allow you to cash in your winnings.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
This way, please.
Okay.
Great. As you make your way back towards the front of the establishment, cashing in your winnings for $22,000.
I'm lucky. I told you I'm lucky.
No, you're not lucky. It was my mind. I literally cheated. I was here.
The individual that's following you leans in and whispers to you, "Can you refrain from using the word cheated when you are next to the cashier, please?
We'd like to
avoid problems."
She cheated on me, that's what
it Yeah, was. I cheated on him and I deserve this money because he cheated first.
Maybe just don't use the word cheated.
Kind right.
Of like bomb kind of
a bomb got
okay,
it.
Okay, well, just okay.
You're in
okay.
a casino.
I tried to make it better, but.
Yeah.
All right, cool. Okay. Let's do it.
Okay. Yep.
All right. So we walk with
You him. Walk outside and the second you get outside, guy kind of looks around like, Jesus Christ, can the two of you just, what the fuck's wrong with you?
I mean, to be fair, I'm stuck with him, so I mean,
look, you came in a blazing hot.
You had your hand reaching for
Yeah, and I still have my hand on my gun. You guys, look, we've been advised by Jin to collect you. Apparently, Jin would like to speak with you. She's been looking for you.
Oh. Yeah, get with this Jin. Like, I don't know who that is.
What's she want?
She wants to meet with you. I just said that. What the fuck is wrong with you two?
Well, we have a really busy
Can you just
schedule.
Act normal? Like, adults, can we have a discussion like adults? Could we do that?
I do my taxes. Is that what you want? I don't know, man. Let's just go. Let's just do this.
If you guys are really who she says you are, could you not, you know...
Who she say was...
Yeah, who did she say?
Yeah, what'd she say about us?
There are 8 guarded men here to escort you. We know... Oh my God. We know that you are... enhanced individuals.
It's not that type of enhanced.
Just try to be a little bit more inconspicuous. You know, Vegas doesn't really take...
We didn't seem all that...
You just walked up to a table with $10 and came out with $22,000. You're lucky to be getting out of there alive and that we got to you first.
And you have both your nipples out.
Exactly, what she said. What the what are you wearing? Like, try to blend in a little bit.
Have you seen people in Vegas?
Oh my God.
Have you seen people having fun in Vegas? Me.
Just, please, can you,
Fine.
As he waves his hand over, you notice a long limo parked next to the casino.
Yes.
No.
What?
It's not a party.
Well, it's still a limo. I can get excited for this.
I don't feel comfortable getting in there.
What do you want, a Chevy? Like, what? It's a limo.
You don't feel comfortable getting in...
A limo?
In the vehicle that is here to escort you to our boss. That...
Where are we going?
Oh, my
God. I'm a woman. I should ask questions. I'm not just going to get in a car with somebody that I don't know.
Ma'am.
Is she like on speed
Is it,
dial?
Do I have to keep them conscious?
We can hear you!
I'm aware. Understood. I do not have to keep you conscious, so... Can we just, please...
Just get in the car.
Get in the car.
They obviously, if they would have done something, they would have done it by now.
You promise not to hurt us?
Sure, why not?
That didn't sound very convincing at all.
I promise not to hurt you. Just get in the nice vehicle that my boss has provided for you to meet you. Now, to my understanding and to my boss's understanding, this is a meeting that has been prearranged. Why you are late, why you are not there is none of my concern, but why you would avoid this meeting is, in fact, quite rude and is making a lot of us very uneasy.
Fine.
All right.
Okay.
Get in the limo.
Thank you. Now,
Don't touch, don't drink any, don't touch
before anything. Before he shuts the door, he's like, now could you tell me where the other individuals are?
Across the street.
He kind of looks up and sees you leaned up against a window outside of a gas station. And the other two?
They went looking for Jen.
Oh, just tell them all of our secrets.
Why is that a secret? We had a scheduled meeting.
We didn't have anything scheduled.
He kind of waves to a couple of the individuals to go across the street. As you're sitting across there, you see a long limo parked outside of the casino across the street, and six armed individuals start walking across the street towards you. Oh, what do you do?
I was leaning against the thing. I go inside and try to get the gas station attendant who is playing with the thing I made to let me in. So I'm walking in. Hey, bud. Do you have like a restroom I could use real quick?
Points to a sign. Says restrooms for paying customers only.
I did pay. I gave you the thing I made.
Is that Amex?
You can call it Amex if you want to.
I'm not going to call it Amex.
What are you going to call it?
Said his name's Gassy the Gas Can.
Oh.
I'm Gassy the Gas Can.
Gassy, not now, baby. Not now.
I'm Gassy the Gas Can.
No, mama's talking.
You're not my mom. I thought we were equals.
Oh, honey, I'm definitely your mom. And I'm looking around. The guys are obviously
coming directly towards
coming
you.
Directly towards me. Since I cannot get in, I hit the floor, hoping that it's
so you get down
they
on the
don't
floor.
See me.
You hear the sound of the ching of the thing, and you kind of look up, and you can kind of see the top of the gas station attendant's head, and you see him just kind of go. And then you follow the trail of his hand up to the other individuals who are standing in the doorway looking down at the floor. Ma'am, we have a car for you. If you'd like to get up off the floor, please. Please.
I fell down.
Do you need help getting back up?
I'm Gassy the Gas Can!
Gassy! Shut the fuck up!
That's Gassy the Gas Can. She made it, it's pretty cool. Not its mom, though.
Totally Gassy's mom.
They all kind of lean over and help pick you up off the floor. Just, and then they let you go. Just please, we have a car waiting for you.
It's a lot of guns.
Not gonna have a problem here, are we?
This ends up like the formation video, I swear to God.
Your friends are in the car already. Can you just join us, please?
I try to look in the car and see if I see anybody.
You just see tinted windows.
Show me.
Show you what?
That my friends are in the car.
Walk across the street with us and you'll see them in the car.
That sounds dumb.
Hey, Bob, next to you guys. Yeah. Are you, oh my God. Can the two of you please open the moonroof and wave to your friend across the street?
Yeah.
As you climb up and you see Karen across the way. Are you happy, ma'am?
Dude, when did we get a limo?
I don't know, just shut up.
Oh, God.
I start walking towards the limo.
That's great. As you start walking away outside in the street, you hear in the distance the sound of,
no, don't leave me. No!
Hey. Hey. Hey, that wasn't the deal. And he starts banging on the windows. I'm gonna tow your truck. That wasn't the deal!
I'm not as much.
That wasn't the deal!
I walk into the limo. I open the door.
Hey.
You want you want a drink?
No.
What do they have?
Everclear.
What?
What? No, we need to, everyone needs to be sober. You
that
need
sounds
to be,
dumb.
No, you need to be of like a sober mind. You don't know where we're going. Fine. If you want to get drunk off your ass, whatever.
The head of the security detail sits across from you all inside the limo as the vehicle starts driving down the road. Wow. Now, I understand there's two more of you. And where might they be?
We don't know. They took off.
To where?
Off.
To Vegas.
You have no way to communicate with him.
That's a really good point you just brought up. We probably should have thought about that before we split up. I didn't at all. Didn't DK used to have his phone?
Gave it
he gave it to the dead
Jason,
guy.
Yeah.
Oh, that would have been such a good idea if we would have kept his phone before we. Yeah.
Well, should we go to the hotel? Or?
No, I mean, I.
Hey, boss. Yeah, two of them are apparently somewhere in Vegas. They have no forms of communication, so I'm going to send another couple teams out, see if we can't get an eyes on them. Bringing these to you right now, and I'm sorry.
You're in trouble.
No, I'm sorry that I have to bring the three of you to her because this is an absolute joke.
Whoa. Excuse you?
You're in trouble.
I will not be talked to like that.
Yeah, great. We will not be talked to like that.
Oh, God. I was already babysitting you guys.
We cut to the DK and Dot walking down the strip.
So you see, you're actually working together with Blackjack. And so that's why even though he was saying he's good at Blackjack, hopefully he's working together, and hopefully that's not the game they play because the dealer doesn't actually know which cards they have. See, what they do is they're just hitting it from the deck, and the only way to really game Blackjack is to actually count the cards to know what succession of cards would come based on a random
that's
number.
Amazing.
Yeah. So hopefully they're doing like poker or something like that. That would be the game to like be in someone's mind for. So anything else you want to know from the great 19-year-old?
Yeah. What is, there's like 100 types of poker, right? I assume you're really good at them.
I mean, there's like Texas Hold'em, and there's the one that's not Texas Hold'em that, you know, was very popular in movies before Texas Hold'em.
Right.
Yeah. and, you know, and under that, there's Magic the Gathering.
Yes.
Yeah, that's a good one. You know, I wish they had that in Vegas. You know, they have Grand Prix Vegas, which is cool, but they do Master, you know, Modern format. I like
as the two of you are just walking and talking, you kind of notice coming towards you two individuals in suits that kind of touch their earpieces as they look at you as they're moving directly towards you.
Hey, you notice those weird two guys?
Do you think they know the lady we're looking for?
I was going to say, those are the guys you look out for in poker because they have a good poker.
Oh, okay,
face,
okay.
You know, like, you know.
Do you think they have magic here?
You know,
excuse me, you two.
Yes?
You too. Could you come here, please?
What do we do?
I got this. You know, this didn't work before in the car, but I think it'll work now. We are high school sweethearts, and we've run away from home, and we don't want to talk to anybody. What?
I don't care.
I agree that we don't want to talk to anyone.
Yes, yes.
My boss would like to meet with you.
What?
Just, my boss would like to meet with you. Could you please?
I think he works for the pawn stars.
And he just keeps walking towards you. He's like,
we have nothing to pawn. Look, we have nothing to pawn, okay? You know, we are normal people.
Those guys wig me out a little.
He gets kind of closer to you. My boss, Jin, would like to meet with you.
We've been looking for you. Oh, yeah.
I didn't think it would work. You were totally right.
Yeah.
It's totally
we just walk around, they find us. Here, give me a hug, man. Give me a hug.
Okay.
Yeah. Okay.
Fantastic.
Yeah. We'll go with you. Let's go.
As he's doing that, the other individual that's with him is taking a picture on his cell phone. Like.
Are we still high school sweethearts?
Yeah.
Just. Okay. If you, just come with us. You're. Yeah. Just. We're not too far from you. They didn't seem to get very far. Just pull the car around. We have a limo. For you.
Oh, cool. What?
Just don't tell our parents.
Right. Don't tell our parents. Don't tell our parents.
Yeah, I'm not going to unpack any of that. the car is here. Just, and the door opens and you see the rest of the group inside.
Hey. Guys, you found them too? It totally worked. DK was right.
Yeah, we found them. Congratulations. I have a plan.
That's, you found us. Mm-hmm.
Nope.
Yeah.
We have them all. We're coming to you, ma'am.
Woo.
Do we 100% trust these people?
No, we don't.
But this is the guy Dumoko says we have to meet, so we'll hit the city.
We don't trust that guy either.
Dumoko.
I trust him. Yeah, Dumoko.
Dumoko set this up?
Yep.
I don't like that guy.
Why not?
He's weird, right?
Give us all these secrets. Give us the juice.
He's totally weird, right?
What is the juice?
What's with him and the wolf?
What is
it's
the
where
juice?
You got the jacket, right?
Yes.
By the way, do you have like shirts or something here? Do you have like an extra shirt?
For
him?
not in the rented limo.
Yeah, what a question.
I don't know, it's a limo. I like freebies and, you know, like at
a shirt.
Like
I'm
a
sure
t-shirt
we
gun.
We will
What's up with the
We'll jacket? Get you a shirt.
Thank you.
I don't know.
But yeah, but you are giving us the juice. What is the juice on Dumoko?
Jesus doesn't like that guy.
Okay, what did you already know about the course?
Is he crazy?
He gave us soup.
Soup?
Yeah.
Yeah, dude. Like.
So he fed you?
Yes.
What does he want from you?
Nothing.
I don't know.
Yeah, he says like we need to be good.
But I don't know Dumoko. He's not doing anything without wanting something in return.
Okay. What do you want? What kind of stuff?
My job is to protect my boss.
Dumoko. What about you personally?
Like,
what do you want? You know.
A weird question.
I'm willing in dealing. Okay. We're talking. How do you say? Jiving, you know?
No one says that.
You know, so what do you want? You know, maybe we can take gyrating. Care of you. You know? You know, Jay Scolding, you know, he has like a lot of moves. What? He might be able to do you. You know?
What?
I mean, sorry. I mean.
What do you mean, man?
He might be able to.
Hey, it's all right. Like, we don't have to be like so, like, lame and heteronormative, you guys.
Can I talk to the adult in the group?
Yes.
That's me.
What?
That's me. I'm the adult.
No. What are you drinking?
I don't.
Would you like some?
No.
No.
No, what? She cannot have any.
I was drinking at like 13.
What?
Yeah, we can tell how it turned out for you. Dot is not old enough to drink. Dot is not drinking. You guys shouldn't be drinking either.
Yeah.
You don't even know where we're going. You guys are going to be intoxicated.
Yeah.
I think he still wants to talk to
okay,
me. He's
yes,
doing the whole, I'm so.
I want to talk.
You guys are so boring. I crush your face.
Do you see what I have to deal with? So I step out of the car. Why are you? Did we stop?
Can you roll your mic for me,
never
please?
Started.
No, you were driving.
I didn't hear. It's so dark in here. I couldn't tell we were going.
Can you roll your mic for me?
I didn't know he had started driving away. I thought we had stopped. What am I rolling?
Roll your mic for me.
It's dark. I couldn't tell we were moving.
What's a D12?
Oh.
Seven.
Is five your luck?
So as you guys are moving.
Five is my luck.
Oh, five's your luck? Mm-hmm. Okay, so you don't get hurt when this happens. As you guys are moving down the strip and he asks to speak to you and they all start talking over each other, Noah just like looks up at him and is like, okay, and opens the door and steps right out.
Oh my god! Oh my god! Oh my god!
As she hits the ground, she immediately gets up and starts to run down an alleyway away from the vehicle.
I gotta find it. I have somebody. Okay, where's the payphone? Where's the phone? Where's the phone? There's a phone. Oh my god, I have some coins.
So you walk up to the payphone. Okay. All right. That's a good use of a plot point there.
I have some coins from my
spin that around in your favor.
Spendings.
That's what they're for.
Okay. Shit. And no. Wait, hang on. Calm down. Noah, calm down. Calling.
Yeah. Yeah.
Hello?
Yeah.
Who is this? Who am I talking to?
Noah.
Oh, God.
Hey.
This is not the number that I meant to call.
No, you got the right number. Solomon's out right now.
Okay. When
he's busy.
When is he coming back? This is an emergency.
He'll be back.
No.
When are you getting back?
I've been trying to get
been
back.
Waiting there, for you.
No. There was a plan, and the plan got messed up, and things aren't going right, and now we're in a limo, and there's not all of us. By the way, there's only some of us, and we're in a limo, and I don't know where we're going, and I need to talk to Solomon.
Whoa, you're talking real fast there. Come on, calm down. Just talk to me.
No, I don't want to talk to you. I want to talk to Solomon. Where is he?
He left me in command for the moment, told me to answer his calls for him. I am not his secretary, I am second in command.
Okay, well, he hasn't called me back in a while.
He's very busy right now. Made a big play yesterday.
Yeah, well, I have a lot of precious cargo that I'm trying to take care of.
Who's your cargo?
You know who my cargo is, okay?
How many of them?
Four.
I mean, those are pretty decent odds to get through activation like that.
Yeah, well, I don't know how much longer we're gonna be safe for, okay? I don't, they're in a limo right now.
Where's Simon? Where's Simon? Solomon put him in charge.
Well, no, I mean, I was also in charge, and I don't know what, he took off.
Simon took off?
Yeah, he took off.
Really?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Why is that funny?
Because I'm pretty sure we've been cleaning Solomon's bits up out of the facility for the last couple hours.
You're at the bunker?
It was a test. A little test there.
Okay.
Thought we'd come help out when we heard about the thing that got loose. We just figured you guys were dead. Hadn't scraped you up off the floor yet.
We're very not dead.
No, I see that. And you left.
Yeah, because we were in danger.
Yeah, ran away. No, it's cool. I'm sure Solomon will be really happy with that.
I don't appreciate your tone. And I would really just like to talk to Solomon.
He's
okay,
not
I don't
here.
Know how much longer
I'm
that
second
I have.
In command,
okay, I
not
don't know.
A secretary.
Okay, I don't know how much longer I have, okay? You're not listening.
Yeah, I'm listening. Where are you?
In Vegas.
Where in Vegas?
I don't know. There.
Who are you with?
I'm not with anyone right now. I left.
You left?
Yeah, I just...
You left the cargo?
Yes. I had to. I didn't know where we were going, and I didn't want to be trapped.
Trapped? With who?
A djinn.
Djinn, okay.
Djinn.
Okay. Well, you know what? We'll get some people on that. Hang tight.
Hang tight.
Try to stick with the group. You know, that'd be good. That's some precious cargo you got on your hands.
Well, it would have helped if, you know, you guys had contacted me because I had a very set plan and the plan got changed.
Simon was in charge.
No, I was also in charge, like, equally as Simon.
I don't know about that.
Yeah.
Solomon put Simon in charge.
No, Solomon told me that I was also equally in charge.
Right, but then he put Simon in charge. So, I mean, I see your situation here. You do sound quite upset. You know, I'm just glad to hear you're alive. We thought you were dead. So, you know, good on you for that.
Okay, could you
good
tell
Good on you for that.
Yeah, could you, so I'm, I see like a Krispy Kreme donut and a Walgreens.
I'm writing this down, yeah.
Why you sound sarcastic?
Okay, because I'm being very sarcastic. Look, we're gonna figure out who this djinn is. Stick with the cargo. Keep in touch. I'll let Solomon know you called. You're a big girl. Take care of yourself. Take care of the cargo. I'm sure everything's fine. Look, we got some big players on the board now. We're not too worried. We just make sure they don't fall into the wrong hands. Oh, but you know what? I am pretty curious cleaning up all this gunk off the floor. This doesn't look like a normal activation over here. What went down?
I want to talk to Solomon. I'll tell him what happened.
I'm in charge right now?
Yeah, I know.
Second in command?
Okay, well, I would rather hear that from Solomon, and I'll believe it when I hear it from him.
Great, so...
Plot point.
Okay.
She turns around. I'm standing there.
What?
I'm standing there. I ran after her. And I'm looking at her, and I say, I can't believe you. I can't believe you. Almost took my $22,000?
No, shh, quiet. Just...
You took off with my money.
Is there a problem?
No.
Who are you talking
Look,
to?
I'm just, not.
Did you tell him you took my money?
Stop.
Figure out who this djinn is. If she wants to meet you so bad, it'd be good to know. A lot of big things happening soon. You know that.
Fine.
Stay with the cargo. You know it's the right thing to do.
Okay, go fuck yourself. Tell Solomon that... But that's where we'll be.
Yeah, I'll tell him you're missing.
Stop! Stop touching me!
She ran away with money.
Stop.
Ma'am, why did you jump out of the car?
I just needed some fresh air.
Who are you on the phone with, ma'am?
My grandma's sick.
You turn and you see that the individual with the rest of the security detail is now standing about 30 feet behind Jay. Your grandma's sick.
I just need to check in on her.
You know, I could use my phone.
I didn't, she, you know, believe, doesn't,
Are you gonna
cellular.
Get back in the car or is there gonna be a problem?
You are talking to your grandma.
No, there's not gonna be a problem.
Okay. As you guys all get back in the vehicle and drive a little bit further down the strip, pulling out in front of a large casino, bright lights, they escort you through the entryway. And as you're walking through, Jay, you start to feel something start to overwhelm you. I'm gonna use a plot point here. As you look around, you see just a sea of green surrounding you. You start losing track of all the faces in the area, as you just start seeing different glowing orbs of green in all these different places, they start overcoming your vision, and you guys start to see as you look over at him going pale and starting to walk a little bit slower and not very sure of his step. Is everything okay?
He's probably drunk.
Are you okay?
No. I can feel. Feel a little weak.
Is everything? You see, the rest of you see the security, the head of security detail, put his hand on his pistol. Is everything okay?
You don't need to. He's just had too much to drink. He was drinking Everclear.
Yeah. That's it. I'm fine.
As you say, you're fine. About 50 individuals within a 100-foot radius just drop.
Everclear does that.
As they hit the ground around you, You hear the sound of screams letting out as Jay just feels this kind of energy overcoming him, and he can feel all the sickness and all of the disease and all the individuals in the surrounding area as it just starts building and building and building as more individuals start to drop and they drop. Sir, I'm gonna need you to calm down. I'm gonna need you to calm down.
I don't know what's happening. I don't know what's happening.
What's happening to him?
I use a plot point, and in a fit of panic, I just look at Jay. I'm like, I am so sorry. And I just swing at him as much as I can to try and knock him out right cold.
I'm gonna need you to roll your might for me.
I got 7.
So you hit him with the right hook, and he immediately goes down and hits the ground. People are now screaming and running in all directions. What the fuck was that?
And then I use another plot point, and I often say, you see, you know, we're enhanced. And as I talk to him, I get closer and closer, and it's like, you know how, you know, we get, and look, I promise you, we will not hurt you. And I extend my hand to shake it. And as soon as he extends his, I will reach and crush his gun using that dense grip. Just crush it, just crush his gun. I won't hurt him, but his gun, you'll be removed from this earth with the crushing of my hand, because the density of the crush and the PSI of the pressure with the crush and the density of the crushing in my hand, I will do that, but my face.
As people are screaming and you see bodies lying all around you, as you reach out and crush the gun, you hear the sound of the other 7 security detail all drawing their weapons on the group of you. As you hear the sound of a loud bang, and you see a woman standing across the way, extremely proud and strong, with with a business suit, long black hair and glasses, with a large cane. Everyone out of the building now.
Okay.
No, you stay.
Okay.
Clear the area. All of you. All of you.
Okay.
We'll get on your knees now.
I would get on my knees.
That's how
that I'm. Yeah. I get on my knees.
I slowly fall flat on the floor again, much as I did the first time. So now I'm just completely flat on the floor like this with my head down.
I walk up, extending my arms.
She walks up to meet you. I need you to roll your action for me.
I probably already goofed it. 2, my luck.
But what is your dice?
2.
No. What die are you rolling for your action?
D8.
That's not gonna be good enough. Because the highest you can get is an 8.
Oh, okay.
She's a little stronger than you.
Okay.
As she takes her cane and immediately puts it out and hits you right in the balls, square center, dropping you to your knees.
Oh.
As she then takes the other side of her cane and puts it up against the side of your head, you will kneel.
Well, if you're gonna hit somebody in the balls, then I guess so. I guess so.
The rest of you on the ground.
Already there.
Fine.
Found the ground.
And that's where we're gonna end this week's episode.
Yay!
Woo! Guys, that was a fucking episode.
Oh, we traveled a lot.
Oh, man.
Yeah. Thank you so much for watching that craziness. Holy shit. For all the viewers that are watching, before we start getting into donations and giving you all the thank yous and all the other stuff, I want to remind everyone about the giant charity drive we have going on this weekend, 48 hours long, starting Friday at 11 a.m. with Jennifer Hale and Aaron. This is how this charity drive is going to work. We've created special software starting at 11 a.m. We're telling the story A couple of you probably watched a couple weeks ago when Lucas and I played around with different voices in Streamlabs that allow you to tip with different voices, and we told the story of kind of a robot drama where Lucas ended up being the last human alive and the robots killed everyone, only because Lucas chose not to confront his robot girlfriend about how uncomfortable he was with the situation, and they killed everyone. So, there's been a robot apocalypse, and the chat room is going to be able to tell the story of the robot apocalypse while tipping for charity, and we've created a special piece of software with PillowsAct that will allow you to use the hashtag of the voice you want to be read out, and then the message, and Aaron Fitzgerald and Jennifer Hale will be playing as individuals in this robot apocalypse, acting out and pantomiming what's happened after the apocalypse, where Lucas's consciousness has survived through a plastic doll that is known as Conan the Barbarian, because it's a half Barbie doll, half Conan doll that survived the robot apocalypse. It's fucking nuts.
That's amazing.
So for 48 hours, that's one of the events that we're gonna be doing this weekend. We have a lot of role-playing games, live improv comedy, music, all sorts of great stuff. It's gonna be 48 hours of absolute awesome supporting the Halo Foundation starting Friday, 11 a.m. It's going to be absolutely nuts. So, holy crap, guys, that was an intense episode of all sorts of crazy stuff. We got some shit happen. Let's go through the tips that came in and thank everyone for their contributions to the show. I think the boss tonight in the Bit War was a little OP. Like a little OP. PillowsAct was apparently super OP.
Oh.
So, shit. As we've said, this is a system that's in flux. Last week, we obviously made the boss way too easy. So this week, we purposely made it too hard so we can keep testing the system, figuring out where it needs to be because we're creating a game from scratch. So we gotta figure it out. All right, let me get into this. Did you guys have fun?
Oh, yeah.
That was good.
Dude, I feel so bad though. These plot points came in late and I couldn't find any way to use them.
Yeah, they did come in late. Luckily it all goes to a great cause.
Yay!
Which is the show.
Yay!
Making sure the show survives.
Yeah, it helps.
Which is awesome.
What a great cause.
Yeah, great cause.
All right, let's get into it here. Looks like we've got Uber Baldi. Is that the future squirrel girl I see? Hashtag dot. T down under. Hashtag lead narrator, Zach, put them through some hell tonight. Evil GMs are the best. Heretic Rada. I could be playing with Japanese cartoon robots right now, but fuck that shit. Here's some money thrown to DK for those fucking pipes, brah. Seriously though, playing with robots is so damn addicting, says Heretic Rada. Erdens, awesome job on Vanquish. Y'all have been doing such an amazing job on the show so far. Here's for Noah, since she seems to have been forced to be the adult dealing with the children.
Thank you.
Seriously. Fret Noise, 5 for DK for being right about the coffee. Heretic Rada, can Dot read maps? She can now.
Aw.
Supalot, hashtag Noah, drive it like you sold it. Stole
I
it.
I did.
Heretic Rada, take it all off, Jay. Take it all off. Give the ladies nightmares and or new fantasies, especially hashtag Noah.
No.
Working class hero, birds gotta fly, Stickum's gotta stick.
Yes.
Seriously, we're gonna take your drawing of Stickum. I'm putting that on a t-shirt, and that is exactly what it's gonna be. I made a note. I was like, that is happening. It's gonna be Stickum, and it's gonna be birds gotta fly, Stickum's gotta stick. It's fucking perfect. Poor Valiant. Heretic Rada, go forth and seduce that cop, Jay. Use your powers for good. Merrick, Dot, Jay, got a plot point. And remember, Amex only. That character was an NPC from season 1 of Vanquish that is DTD Merrick. So.
Yay!
Actually, no, it was Geek 40. Sorry, Merrick's a
way
different character.
We're sorry we took your friend
There's so
away.
Many NPCs. Geek 40 is that character. DTD Merrick is a different one. 100 eggs, hashtag DK. Merrick, Noah, let's get them all one since PZ is a god. Cupcake therapy. Gassy believes in everyone having a plot point. Oh. Confetti for everyone. Hashtag lead
Thank
narrator.
You.
Red.
Mark CL. Lead narrator. As someone who isn't American, what's the deal with Amex? Like, why do all these gas stations only take one credit card? That's a terrible business model. Are they government fronts meant to push away real customers?
Yes.
Yama says, hashtag lead narrator, and then Merrick, hashtag lead narrator for get sanity. Awesome. So thank you guys so much for your contributions.
Thank you.
Thank you guys so much. We really do appreciate you contributing to the show, helping keep this crazy show alive. If you like it, let us know on Twitter. We love hearing your feedback on the show. If you have fan art, let us send it to us. We're going to start doing fan art videos before the show as that stuff starts coming in. We really love doing this. It's really fun to play in the Valiant universe. And we haven't even like broke the surface of the Valiant universe yet. This is just getting to know this team. Before long, we're going to have to get deep into the Valiant universe, and it's going to get nuts, especially considering how the easiest things seem really difficult for this group. So I talked to, we just got a subscriber, Sparrow! Sparrow G just subscribed. Yay. Thank you for that.
Thank you so much, Sparrow G.
And thank you for all the other subscribers that came in. We really do appreciate it. I was talking over the weekend to Mike Rowe, who's playing Ninjak in Ninjak vs. the Valiant universe, about coming on the show. And about how Ninjak would probably want to kill every single person in this group because he doesn't do well with kids and especially with people who are incompetent. So it will be really interesting when we start bringing those guests onto the show.
So I would still be alive.
You did get out of a moving car today.
I couldn't see through
but
the
But you ran with that, literally.
It was
that
amazing.
Was
good work.
Planned it. That was a plan all along.
It was planned.
Yeah, it was a plan all along. Definitely. And maybe we'll find out later what happened to Jim and Jason. It's gonna be real interesting. Real interesting. So tune in next week, 9:30 p.m. And make sure to tune in this weekend for the 48-hour-long charity drive that supports the Halo Foundation. It's going to be nuts. And that starts in 2 days, and we have a lot to do. So we're going to call it a night. Thank you guys so much.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.